Mr. Harrison! And the bench. Jonathan Weyer, Luca Kloppenburg, Max Eckermann, Darren Heise, Robin Buchwald, Ron Homeda, Herwig und Steffen Demossi. Now we ask, ladies and gentlemen, that we all please rise, remove your hats, as we play the country's national anthem. First, the United States national anthem. We ask you to remain standing now for the national anthem from Germany. And now for the two most famous words in all sports, play ball!
And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Excuse me. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Uni-Trade Stadium for game number 4 Game number four of our Pony League Palomino World Series. We're here at Uni-Trade Stadium. This is our fourth game today. Today's fourth game is going to put Laredo All-Star team against the German team from Paderborn, Germany. Now, earlier we like to look at the fun facts on our teams. This is Paderborn's first trip here to the World Series, and they are a distance of 5,465 miles away. A little bit further than the teams we saw earlier today. So sit back, relax, enjoy today's ball game. It is going to be a beautiful, beautiful game here in Laredo, Texas. It's 7:48, close to 8 o'clock. We're getting ready to get this game on the road, on its way. Let's look at the weather reports real quick just to see where we're at right now for everybody. Right now here in Laredo, we've cooled down a little bit. We're at 101. Feel like it's 105. But we're at 101 degrees here right now. So sit back, relax, enjoy the ball game. I'm Kenneth Duncan along with my partner, Orly Navarro. Orly, what do we got?
Well, you know, I want to just say that you're in your fourth game. I know the voice. You did opening ceremonies. So I can see where you're tired and your voice is tired. But, yes, welcome, everyone. We are in Laredo, Texas. We're playing here at beautiful Uni-Trade Stadium. This is the fourth game. This stadium is a AAA stadium established in Laredo, Texas in 2012. This is the home site for the Mexican League baseball team, Laredo Tecolotes. They're actually called Laredos de los Dos. Excuse me, Tecolotes de los Dos Laredos, meaning they play half their home games in Laredo, half their home games in Mexico. So it's the only team in the Mexican League that does that. So this is a AAA field. The mound is a little bit lower than most mounds. So you're going to see the pitchers having to be accustomed to that. But it seems like these young gentlemen have been able to adjust. The temperature has gone down. It's a beautiful night. Blue skies, very little clouds. We're getting ready for the first pitch.
All right, here we go. Up to bat now for Laredo is number six, Joel Hinojosa. And the first and the ball game is on its way with a caught strike number one on Hinojosa. And there's a strike number two. Beautiful pitch in there by this right-hander from Germany. Ball just on the inside.
The pitcher for Germany is Patrick Gary Harrison.
There's a windup and the pitch. Slow chopper over to the shortstop. Fields it cleanly, throws it over to first. Not in time, a little bobble there. Yeah, he fielded it nicely, but that throw was just a little bit off. Took a little hop. Runner beat out the throw either way to first base. Safe on first.
And we've seen that all day. This is a infield that's all turf. And even where the shortstop, second baseman, third baseman, and first baseman are playing, there's turf. There's only dirt around home plate, pitcher's mound, and the bases. So the ball is running a lot slower. So as a shortstop, you expect the ball to come to you a little bit faster. It is not. Shortstop and second baseman have to charge in a lot faster. That was a perfect example of not charging in fast enough, thinking the ball would get to you. The runner was safe.
And the runner's going. Here goes the throw to second base. Not in time. Still second base for Laredo.
How about that? Laredo starting off with a steal. They get on base, move them over. We've noticed that every team tries to get aggressive to get to score early and try to hold that lead. Once the games have progressed, we've seen the pitchers kind of relax and start taking over. So it's those early innings where we've seen some scoring happening. And then all of a sudden later in the game, you see it kind of die down simply because the pitching is getting more relaxed. They're more accustomed to the mound and they start playing better. So right now, Laredo trying to take advantage of the situation with a man on second.
As the ball is just a little bit outside, we got a 2-2 count now on our batter. Garcia. Nomar Garcia there as the batter. Swings and a miss for a big strikeout.
That was a big strikeout. You know, I say that the pitcher has to get ready. It looks like Harrison is doing his job, and he's very comfortable on the mound. And so it's just a matter of that, getting comfortable on the mound.
Yeah, that was number three, Alan Vidal, that struck out on that one. Now we got number 14 up here, Nomar Garcia. There's the windup and the pitch. Nice pitching there for strike number one. As we're getting ready to settle in here to the top half of the first inning, it's 0-1 count, one out, runner on second base. Nice, strong hit to center field. Center fielder comes in on that. Second base. I'm sorry. Well, it was a pop fly, line drive. The runner was going. It was a hit and run situation.
It was a hit and run situation, so he was already at third base. There was no way he can get back. So double play for Germany to end the top of the first.
After one half inning of play right now, your score is still Laredo 0, Germany getting ready to come up.
You know, you wonder with all the traveling, Germany has traveled many miles to get here, and the fatigue maybe that sets in, but they actually got here on Wednesday. So they've been here to where they've been able to adjust to the time zone, adjust to just being here. They got to come out to the field and practice. So it just I would think they're ready to play. They're ready to play. They've been able to relax in the hotel and then come out and play. You know, other than that, and I just think it's just a matter of adjusting to the climate. But for the most part, Germany's ready to play today.
Yeah, not sure what the temperature is in Paderborn, Germany, where these young men are from. So I can't tell you how it is, how they'll feel, you know. But here down in Laredo, like I said earlier, right now it's 101, feels like 105. It is nighttime, so the sun is starting to go away. The lights are coming on here at the stadium, here at Uni-Trade Stadium. I'd like to take a moment, Orly, we've been here all day long, going back and forth. And, I'd like to say thank you to my wife. For letting me come out here. Thank you, Anna, for letting me come out here and play with Orly today. Yeah. And also, I want to say hi to my daughter, Katie. Hopefully, she's listening and watching the game at home, getting ready to go to sleep. But hi, guys. I love you. Be home after the game's over.
And on that note, I'd like to reach out to all the family members, all the family in Germany, all the family of our Laredo athletes. If you'd like to message us on YouTube, go right ahead. Kenny here reads them out, and he'll try to answer as many questions as possible. We'd love to hear from our friends in Germany. I know there's a lot of parents watching their kids. We're taking very good care of them. I said this earlier today. The city of Laredo spends all year to prepare for this. They have meetings with the police department, fire department, the hospitals, all the city officials. Everybody knows this tournament's going on. Your child is in our city, and once your child is in our city, it becomes our child, and we take care of them. So I hope the parents out in Germany are enjoying the broadcast and know that your child's doing fine and they're enjoying this beautiful stadium.
Yes, sir, and up to bat first for Germany is number five. Oh, I just pushed my screen over there. Number five, Jonathan Weyer. And Mark Harrison says, my brother's on fire. Go, Padman. Yes, sir, here we go.
He is looking good early.
There's the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss for strike number one. Called strike number two there.
I can tell you right now, I'm excited. These two pitchers can throw. Laredo's pitcher.
And there's the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss for strike number three. Sits him down.
Francisco Hernandez for Laredo looks good on the mound early. Harrison for Germany looks good on the mound for them. You know, I think this is just one of those games where you've got to score and then hold that lead. I don't expect this game to be a blowout. I expect this game to be very tight all the way, seven innings. this year.
Next at the bat for Germany is number 10. One and one's a count. Looks like it's Eckermann, number 10 Eckermann's up to bat for Germany. One-one, one out, bottom of the first inning. Here's the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss for strike number two. You know, so far both of these pitchers are bringing some serious heat to this game.
But what I like is that they're swinging the bats. You know, that's important. The batters have to try to put the ball in play. You can't just stare at the pitches.
Okay, foul ball there on that one. One and two still the count. And we do have a lot of the teams still staying here for the watching the ball game. We just had the opening ceremonies of today's program. So we do have a lot of the teams here still hanging out. That ball was just a little bit high. Check that up to bat is number 10, Bedlin.
And he's doing a good job at the plate, swinging, you know, trying to make something happen. But he's battling in there. And let me tell you, a lot of people are here because they were excited to hear Germany was coming. You know, they were announced and everybody knew they were coming. And it's just, who is that team? You know, they're all here because they want to see Germany play.
There's the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss for strike number two. I'm sorry, for out number two. That was a strikeout there. It's a second strikeout in a row now. Yeah, we're working on our roster here. We do apologize if we said the wrong names. We're getting the rosters corrected so we can have the right jersey numbers.
I like Rommelman. Rommelman comes to the plate, and he shakes the umpire's hand. That's how you do it as a batter. You know, he probably has a high average. You know, if you're nice to the umpire, good things will come.
He's going to be nice to you.
Do you think?
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah, well.
You know, and you know, here's the thing that I've seen, you know, so far in this. Again, this is our fourth game that we've done today. I called that one strike. You know, every player that's come up, especially the international players I've seen from Puerto Rico that's come up, players from Illinois also, first thing they do is they come up, they do acknowledge the umpire. You know, give him a fist bump or give him a handshake. You know, it's truly a good thing to see, you know.
It's a good thing to see, but, you know, I just never did it. But just being honest, but these players, hey, man, if it helps, do it.
I think sometimes I might have kicked dirt on the umpire or something. And there's a chopper over to the third baseman, picks it up, throws it over to first, in time, retires the side. After one complete inning of play here from Uni-Trade Stadium, the score remains 0-0 Laredo against Germany. That was a 1-3 inning for Laredo there. Took Germany out pretty quick on that one.
We talked about early in the day, we talked about base running, being heads up, hustling. All those things have to happen in this game today. If you hit a grounder and you think it's going to be an easy out, you better run it out, because we've seen players beat the throws because of the adjustment to the AstroTurf. The timing's just off just a little, so you can run out a grounder to shortstop and get there. When you're running the bases, you keep your head up. Instead of getting one base, you possibly can get two. That's happened. So those are the kind of plays that both teams have to kind of consider when it comes to hustle, being smart on the bases. Those are the kind of things that will get them a run, because these pitchers are bringing it today. So it's going to take taking advantage of maybe an error by somebody. And so that's what I've seen in the early games, and that's what I think is going to happen today, especially with this game.
Yeah, so far it's been a pitcher's duel. Pitches are on right now. You know, we're only in through the first inning, but the pitchers are doing a great, great job out there. And like you said, Orly, I think there's going to be an error somewhere. that's going to cause that runner to keep advancing and move forward for either team.
And it could be not even an error, just somebody just didn't run as hard. You know, something small could make a big difference.
Up batting for Laredo is number 12, Sergio Galvan. There's a windup, just a bit high there, ball number one. We'd like to thank our statistician, Gene Belmades, for getting us the proper jersey numbers for Germany there so that we're not calling the wrong names.
Right. And also, he'll be announcing tomorrow.
Oh, yeah,
he's
Gene
on tomorrow.
Will be
yeah,
on tomorrow,
we're not letting him talk today because, you know, we're going to surprise people tomorrow.
We got to save his voice.
Save his voice, that's right.
He's a prima donna. There's a swing over to the third baseman. Bobbles a little bit, shortstop. Oh, bobbles it also. Runner is safe at first. That got underneath the third baseman's glove, then again through the shortstop's glove. That could be that one that we're talking about, the concentration and watching that ball on that turf. This could be what we're talking about.
Yeah, and most of it's the turf. You know, how long has Germany had a chance to play on this turf? An hour, a couple of hours? That's all they've got, you know. So they're adjusting as the game goes on. They're understanding how the turf is playing a little bit. So, you know, you can't really blame them. They're just having to figure this out.
Next up to bat for Laredo is number 15, Francisco Hernandez. Takes a first ball strike. Runner at first base. No outs here in the top of the second inning.
Remember the last time Laredo had a runner on base? They took off. They stole right after the second pitch. They took off. So we'll see if Coach Canales continues that kind of aggressive play on the base path.
I scared him back to first base, just checking him, making sure he's staying honest. There's a windup, pitch is high. Catcher kicks up, looking down the first baseline, making sure he's not trying to sneak away on him.
You wonder if that was slightly a high pitch, but kind of more like a pitch out. You know, it was kind of a little bit high and outside for the catcher.
Swing and a miss for strike number one. Sorry, strike number two, that's a 1-2 count now. Pitcher settling in, checks over at first base, gets his call from the catcher. There's a windup and a pitch. Runner's going. It's a hit and run situation down the left field line. Left fielder's able to scoop it up there to keep the runner at bay at second.
Nice execution on the hit and run.
I think that's what Laredo was trying to do earlier in the game on that first hit and run, but it ended up a nice line drive that was caught by the center fielder and ended up turning that double play. So now here we go. Laredo's up. He's got runners on first and second. No outs here in the top of the second inning. Next up is number 16, Eric Ruiz. He's got runners in scoring position there at second and first base. Squaring around the bunt. First baseman was coming in on that bunt. Pulled the bat back, so that's a ball one for Eric.
You have the first baseman playing on the grass. Third baseman's playing in line with third base. The shortstop, second baseman are playing halfway in.
Pulls that one back again. 2-0 is a count for Eric.
This is a very, very dangerous situation for Germany. You have a left-handed hitter that likes to pull the ball.
And now, there's the first called strike.
He's showing bunt, but if he gets a ball, the second baseman has to cover a lot of ground to cover first base and then get back to his position. So if he were to pull something, that second baseman would have to cover a lot of ground.
Looks like that one's just a little bit low there. 3-1's the count now on Eric. Two men on, no outs here. Top of the second inning for Laredo.
Timeout called.
Timeout's called on the field there. Getting back in the box now. Ball back in play. Runner at first is taking a humongous lead because there's no one guarding him over there. Squares around the bunt one more time. Nice little bunt put down. Looking around. Safe at first. Ball goes out to the outfield. One run scores. They're able to corral the ball back in. Standing by. It is a double for Eric. Goes into second base on the error throw. So it's a single with an error throw. It gets over to second base.
What an excellent bunt he put down. The first baseman charged in, picked up the ball, threw it to the back of the runner. That's what created the problem. But what a bunt that he put down. You know, you don't get them any better than that.
Now, we've seen several teams try to bunt earlier today.
That's right.
This by far has been the best execution that we've seen so far.
On that situation, and we were concerned with that lip on the transition from dirt to this turf, but that ball seemed to...
There's a high fly ball to left center field. Center fielder's getting underneath it. Runner tags up from third base. Here comes a throw right at the cutoff man. Run scores, RBI. That was number eight. Number eight, Gerardo Virial on that sacrifice.
Laredo swinging the bat, running the bases, tagging up. You know, that throw to first base, they get another run in. So now they're up 2-0. Those are the kind of executions you have to get. You have to get those outs.
Next up to bat for Laredo is Mr. Campos there. Takes the first pitch, I'm sorry. Pitcher's in the windup. There's the pitch. Nice shot over the shortstop's head into left field. Runner was going, but he stumbled. Able to get the ball in and hold him back at bay. Number 16 was trucking along. Eric Reese was trucking. He tripped up. Might have been on that lip right there they were talking about. And they were able to hold him at bay.
But what a break, because the left fielder had bobbled the ball.
Yes.
So he would have scored. But simply tripping at third base, what a break for Germany. He had to go back to third, so no run scores.
Next, number 13, Eric Garcia.
Now here comes number 13, Eric Garcia for Laredo coming in. He's got runners on the corner, one out here, top of the second inning. Laredo is threatening one more time, already up 2-0. There's the windup. And the pitch. A little blooper behind the second baseman. Second baseman's able to cover it nicely. Picks that one up.
Nice, beautiful play.
Everybody stays where they're at.
You know, we talk about the pitcher and the composure of a pitcher. You know, those errors on the field can get frustrating for a pitcher who's pitching a good game, you know, and that's just something that Harrison is going to have to do. Keep his composure. It's early in the game. Don't panic. Just pitch your game and just stay in the game, because it could get out of hand if he's not focused on what he's trying to do.
Next up, we have Joel Hinojosa, number 6 for Laredo. Takes the first pitch ball. 1-0 count, 2 outs, runners on the corner for Laredo. Already up 2-0 here in the fourth and final game for today. Harrison settling down, gets a pitch, there's a pitch. Nice pitch in there for strike number 1. 1-1 count.
There you go, that's what he needs to do, just... talk to the catcher.
Settling down one more time. Harrison gets a call. There's the pitch. Nice hard hit over to the shortstop. Picks it up. Flips it over to second base. And they're out of the inning just like that. But not before Laredo scores 2 runs on 2 hits. 1 error committed by Germany. And that was on that bobble, I guess, towards first base when they were on the bunt.
Right. That's right. But again, you go back, you regroup. Germany's getting together right now. The coach is talking to him, letting him know it's early in the game. Don't worry. Brush it off. Telling his pitcher, don't worry about it. You know, let's get the bats going. Laredo on the other side, once again, every game that's been played, those errors tend to hurt. You can't play at this level of play in the World Series and expect that you can make an error and it's not going to hurt you. They do hurt. Run, score, things like that. So now Laredo's up 2-0 on an error, and so now Germany has to battle back. I don't think Germany has a problem with 2-0 lead to buckle down and play. They're here because they're champions of the European area zone, so they know what they need to do. They just need to relax, and maybe that's what they needed, something to wake them up a little bit and say, whoa, you know, we didn't think this was going to happen. So now they're going to get back to it. But those are the championship teams, and that's what they do. I think Harrison is fine. He was able to get out of that inning, so he'll be fine. Laredo now has to really concentrate, because now I think they just woke up one of the stronger teams in the tournament, and it's getting better and better as the innings go by.
Yes, sir. I agree with everything you just said there, Orly. You know, it's one of those, you know, they woke him up. Hey, wait a minute. This guy's just scored two runs on us and possibly a third one if he hadn't have fallen, right?
That's right.
If he hadn't fallen, that would have been 3-0 right now. I think Harrison is okay. He's going to settle down. He's going to get back into his rhythm. We're going to see what they do right now here in the bottom half of the second inning. If they can manufacture a couple of runs right now, I think they're going to be okay. I think either way, they're going to be okay. I think they come on stronger in the later innings. We'll see what happens.
And remember this, Laredo's team is the host team. They're not the South Zone champions. That's Harlingen, Texas. So Laredo's a host team. So Laredo is actually playing against a champion team.
Up to bat for Germany is number 31, Simon. Takes the first pitch foul out to the first base side.
Bomber.
Simon Bomber?
Bomber.
Balmer. With that. Balmer. Yeah. And I do apologize if I'm butchering the names. Please forgive me. I'm lucky I can pronounce my own name. And there's a windup and the pitch. Just high for ball number one. 1-1 count on Simon. That ball was just low. 2-1 now. I think they're looking to get Simon on there. He's the first baseman. Get him on, and they'll start moving around here. There's a windup and the pitch. Just out of the strike zone one more time. 3-1 count now.
Yeah, look at Simon dig in. He knows 3-1. He's looking for something fat to drive into the gap somewhere.
There's the windup and the pitch. And it's called ball four, so Simon takes his trip to first base, gets a free ride.
He's a big guy. You can see that he wants to hit the ball, but what discipline to hold back on a 3-1. A lot of big-time batters like to, just dig in and take a big swing whenever they get a chance. 3-1 is a perfect opportunity to do that. But he had the patience and the understanding that the important thing right now is to get on base. Get on base. You're the leadoff batter. Get on base. And that's exactly what he did.
Next up for Germany is number one, Ian Eberhardt. Takes the first pitch ball. 1-0 is the count. No outs. Runner on first base for Germany here in the bottom half of the second inning. There's the windup. And the pitch. Stays out of the zone, bringing it up to 2-0 the count. The catcher calls timeout, coming out to calm down his pitcher. And here comes the bench coach also there, number 19, is walking out there to talk to the pitcher.
Right, Coach Canales is out there. And one of the things, this is how important that walk was and for how discipline helps here. There hadn't been a runner for Germany on the bases. So the pitcher's been going through the windup. Now with a guy on first base, he's gone to the stretch, and you can see a significant change in how he pitches from the stretch compared to how he pitches from the windup. That's how important it was for Balmer, how important that was to get on base, because now you see a change in the way the pitcher is pitching, and this is where Germany can take advantage.
Back to action now. 2-0 is a pitch count. There's a windup and the pitch. Bringing it up to 3-0 now for Eberhard. 3-0, runner on first base. Pitcher gets the call. There's the pitch. Another free base right there on four pitches.
There you can see the difference. And now first and second for Germany with no outs. But definitely the pitcher now pitching differently, And that was one of the things. You see him on the mound with nobody on base going through the windup, and he's bringing it, and he's throwing hard. When he has to tweak how he throws, it's a different pitcher out there. And I think Germany's realized that. Two walks in a row, now Germany has something going.
Next up to bat for Germany is number 24, Zane Pirmozic. And there is a strike. We haven't seen one of those in a while. Mm-hmm. Oh, and one's the count. Two on, nobody out for Germany.
This was a situation where Laredo bunted everybody over. If you remember, Germany not doing the same thing. Oh, yeah, okay. There it is. There's the
nice bunt.
Nice bunt
back over to the pitcher. Yeah, the big difference that I see in this bunt play is that ball actually stayed up long enough to let the pitcher come off the mound. Pitcher filled it cleanly, was able to turn to third base and take that lead runner out.
I could say this. Laredo, this is their practice field. They know how that ball bounces. That pitcher came off the mound quickly to get to the ball. Germany didn't. The first baseman covered. Here, the pitcher just stormed his way in, got the ball, and threw it to third. So, that's something that home field advantage type of situation where it helped.
Next up to bat for Germany is number 8, Titus Van Kopp. Lit a blooper over the first baseman's head.
I don't know if you just saw what happened there, but the batter was running to first base. If you run to first base, touch first base, and you go out to your right, you're okay. In this case, the runner ran to first base, stopped right at first base, and then stepped off the bag. The right fielder, when he threw the ball in, he threw it into the first baseman, who was able to tag the runner. So, mental error by Germany. You know, just when they're getting the break, they could have had bases loaded with one out. Instead, it's two outs, second and third.
Nice hard hit by the next batter, number 9, Kirchhoff. Brings in one run for Germany, putting runners on the corner now. Now, on that previous play, I think what happened is he was coming up to the base, and you know, the first baseman was there to receive the ball from the outfield. He stumbled a little bit, and he fell.
He fell off the base.
Yeah. He fell off the base, mm-hmm. And he quickly tagged him, which is a smart play by Laredo on that one.
Let me tell you, that last hit was just beautiful.
That was
right
into
center field. Just a nice swing.
Next up to bat for Germany is number 4, Vokil. Mathis Vokil. There's a windup and the pitch. Takes a nice cut at it. Ball goes foul.
In the batter's box, number 4, Vokil.
Oh, and one's the count. Two outs, runners on the corner for Germany. Germany's threatening. If they get a nice hit to the outfield to get something to land, they'll tie this game up. Pitcher's checking the runner at first base. There's the pitch. Runner's going. Oh, he comes back. Guess he didn't want to go to second base.
No, he didn't want to go to second base. I don't know. He didn't get the signal.
Maybe it was a hit and run that should have been a play or something. There he goes. Now he's leading off again. Pitcher's getting the signal from the catcher. Checks over at first. There's the pitch. One and two's the count now on the batter.
Nice discipline.
Now that ball was real, real close. Pitcher's getting a signal from the catcher. Looks over at first base, keeping him honest. There's the windup and the pitch. Little high now. Two and two's the count. Two outs, runners on the corners.
You definitely see a big difference for Hernandez on the mound. You know, once he went to the stretch, it kind of neutralized his power. Now he's having to think a little bit.
Runners going, hitting runs into play. Oh, gets by the diving second baseman. One run scores. Center fielder comes in to corral that ball to keep it from any more damage.
Not necessarily a full swing, but he definitely got it back up the middle. So nice hitting. And that, see, those, we've been talking about little things. And it all started with their leadoff batter being patient enough on a 3-1 to get on first. Once he got on first and the pitcher switched to the stretch, the whole game changed. And now you can see a different Germany. They're hitting the ball. They're running the bases. It's just a stronger team.
Next up to bat for Germany is number 5, Leon Sondersong.
In the box, number 5, Sondersong.
Take that first pitch foul. 0-1's a count, 2 outs, runners on first and second for Germany. Pitcher gets the call. Looking at the batter, checks the runner at second. There's a windup and the pitch. Ball's in the dirt for ball number 1. 1-1's a count. Batter settling in there. Here comes the pitcher. Gets the call. Checks the runner. Here is the pitch. Pop fly to right field over here into the stands. Out of play. Brings up a 1-2 call now. Everybody back to position.
Shortstop's coming in. Just to talk to the pitcher a little bit, because the pitcher wasn't recognizing the runner on second base. And if he doesn't recognize him, there's going to be too big a lead. I think the shortstop came in just to let him know, hey, look back towards me, because if he's taking too much of a lead, you might want to step off the rubber.
And conference is over. At the pitcher's mound, pitcher's getting his signal from the catcher, looking in. Batter steps out. Looks like pitcher took just a little too long, so batter says, you know what, I'm going to make you wait now. Steps out, everybody's getting back into motion. Checks the runner at second, and there's the pitch. Strike 3! Sitting them down. So here we go after 2 complete innings of play. Our score here right now, Laredo 2, Germany 2, both of them getting their runs in the second inning. So far for Laredo, they got 2 runs on 2 hits and no errors. Germany's got 2 runs on 3 hits with 1 error, and that was that error throw that helped bring that run in for Laredo.
That's right. And I think Laredo got off lucky. You know, if that bunt's put down, the runner doesn't get thrown out at third, changes the whole situation. But credit Germany in being patient at the plate, the leadoff batter, understanding what he had to do, the first baseman. I know, big kid, would love to hit it out of the park, I'm sure, but he stayed within what they had to do. We're behind 2 runs. I just need to get on base. Let's get that leadoff runner on base. Changes the dynamics of the game, and I think you saw where Germany took advantage of that. Scores tied 2-2. This has been an interesting ball game.
Yeah, so far, so good. It's been a really nice game here from Uni-Trade Stadium. Game number 4 of today's lineup. Thank you, Orly. I'd like to thank our corporate sponsors, Leindecker Construction, Claymore Family Entertainment Center, the City of Laredo, Laredo Visitors and Convention Bureau, Andy's Air, Parson Whitworth, Borchers and Morales, Rotex, Advanced Spine Solutions, Constantine's Pediatric Dentistry, the Stat Emergency Center, Andy's Mobility, Liquid Studio Group, A-Rod Construction, Sunbed Air Conditioning, Rudy's Real Texas Barbecue, and of course, Blue Top Digital Reaper Graphics. Thank you very much, guys, for sponsoring the Laredo Pony Series here in Laredo, Texas.
So what do you think Harrison's thinking on the mound?
Well, you know, I think Harrison's going to settle down now. They got 2 runs. You know, they were able to get out there, get after it, get the runs back in, tying the game back up. So I think, you know, the coach talked to him, hey, let's settle down. We're back where we want to be. It's an even ball game again. Again, it's like 0-0 because we're both tied. I think Harrison comes in and he stays stable. I think he holds him at bay in this inning.
I think so. You know, you're right. He was in the dugout watching everything that was going on. And, you know, his teammates came through. They came through. They put some runs on the board. That gives him the confidence to go out there and just be the pitcher that he is.
And next up for Laredo is Alan Vidian. Squaring around the bunt. That one flies back to the net. At a 1-1 count now on Allen. If the radar gun's correct, I looked up there at the scoreboard. Looks like Harrison Stone around 87 miles an hour that last pitch.
I don't know if that's working right, but he is bringing it when he brings it. And then he just dropped in a changeup there.
Lays down the bunt. Harrison picks it up, fields it cleanly over to first base. Oh, runner just beat him out. You know, it goes back to what we just talked about. Yeah, Laredo has played on this field before, so they know the ins and outs. They know the bumps on this field. Harrison didn't get off the mound fast enough on that one. But again, this bunt was laid towards the third baseline. It's a little further out.
Yeah, it's a little bit tougher of a play. He didn't have to throw the third. He was throwing the first, so that's a long throw for him. But definitely, that's home field advantage, knowing how the field is, and the pitcher not knowing makes a big difference.
Next up for Laredo is number 14. Runners going in safely at second. Number 14 for Laredo is Nomar Garcia. And we just had a stolen base by number three, Mr. Alan Vidal. You know, Laredo's challenging. They're pushing him. They did this in the first inning also. Nice hit in between the third and shortstop. Left fielder picks it up. They hold the runner at bay. Garcia started heading towards second base. The ball was cut off by the pitcher. They throw it back down to first base. Almost got him sliding back in. But safe all around. First and third for Laredo.
That runner at first base was lucky. He rounded first base thinking that his partner on third was going to maybe try to stretch the go home, and he was looking to advance to second base. When that runner stopped, he was caught in the middle, but the throw was late, so he was able to get back in time.
And next up to bat for Laredo is number 12, Sergio Galvan.
Batting number 12, Sergio Galvan.
No outs, runners on the corner for Galvan and Laredo. Pitcher's getting his signals from the catchers. Checks the runners. There's the pitch. Runner's going to second. They're just going to let him take that one freely there because he had that runner at third. They want to hold him at bay. Stolen base for number 14, Garcia.
And that was a strike on the pitch, so the batter has two strikes.
0-2 is the count now for the batter. Pitcher's getting his call. And there's the pitch. Little chopper down the right field side. Foul ball.
Yeah, you could say this Laredo team's scrappy. You know, they put the ball in play. They make you make the plays. If you don't make the plays, that's where they take advantage of you. So Harrison has got to keep the ball down, continue to let him put it in play.
That's a foul ball right there also. 0-2 is still the count. No outs. Runners on second and third for Laredo here in the top half of the third inning.
And it's frustrating for a pitcher because, you know, he wants to do everything. He wants to help his team. He wants to get all the outs, strike out people. That doesn't happen at this level. He's going to have to learn to relax and let his defense help him.
Nice hit ball into center field. Center fielder fields it cleanly, throws the ball in. One run scores for Laredo. Runner's going to second base. Looks like they might catch him in a little rundown. No one's there. They're looking at towards third base. Gets him out at third base. Yeah, what happened on this one is the runner kind of snuck out, and they saw the runner rounding first base, heading over to second. Kind of threw it down towards the middle. caught the runner on third base off guard, threw it back this way as he's sliding in. They were able to tag him out for the first out of the inning.
You know, you watch that execution, and as the ball's being thrown around, the catcher, after he catches the ball from the outfield, throws a shot to second base. The second baseman had a shot right to his chest. That's what created everything. If that ball's high and everybody jumps around trying to get the ball, or if it goes in the grass, makes it difficult. And what a beautiful play right there by the catcher.
Up to bat is number 15, Francisco Hernandez. That ball was in the dirt. Bounced in front of the catcher, so the runner on first, number 12, he takes off towards second base. Galvan takes off. Pitcher, or the catcher, picks it up, guns it over to second base. Hadn't even started to slide, the ball was already there.
I think we just realized that the catcher from Germany has an arm and can throw.
Just a little. Just
back-to-back plays where we just see the talent of the catcher from Germany.
That ball was just inside. 2-0 is the count. 2 outs now for Laredo. Nobody on. A couple of bang-bang plays there and heads up. A couple of mental errors, I guess, maybe on Laredo's part that caused those out. I mean, they would have still had two people on base right now.
Well, once again, it could be slightly mental errors, but you're also talking about you take one step too much with a guy with an arm, he's going to get you.
That's true. That is true. 3-1 counting it right now on number 15, Francisco Hernandez. Three and one, two outs here at the top half of the third inning for Laredo. And there's the pitch. Caught strike, 3-2 now. There's been a couple of times there the Germany team thinks they're already off the field and got to bring him back.
Yeah, the catcher was all excited, ready to go in. It's 3-2.
Full count now. Two outs, nobody on for Laredo. There's the payoff pitch. In the dirt. Ball does squeeze away from the catcher, but looks like number 15 there, Hernandez, was taking off some hardware, so now he's just running down to first base. Yeah, we saw earlier the Puerto Rican team, they had some situation plays that there were certain things that happened and they took advantage of it.
That's correct.
Remember, Mr. Cruz took some really good advantage of it. I think that was a perfect advantage portion right there. If he would have been hustling down to first base, he would have already been at second because the ball was all the way back over here to the backstop, but I don't think he realized it.
That's exactly right. Those are the little things that you have to look out for. And as a coach, you also have to tell them, hey, guys, remember, if the catcher misses the ball, the backstop is way back there. So you have a chance to cover some ground. So be alive.
Next up for Laredo is number 16, Eric Ruiz. Puts a high pop fly up in the air. They lost it in the lights. Bounces in. Here comes the runner all the way from first base. Scoring. Number 15, Hernandez, all the way from first base. That ball got way up in the sky there. Left fielder's moving in. The shortstop's moving over.
Yeah, that is exactly the hustle you have to, you know, you're on first base, a pop fly to the outfield. You're thinking, oh, that's just a normal out, so you're going to trot around the bases. But the runner on first did not trot. He ran all the way around. He was at third base when they dropped the ball, so he was able to score.
And right now we got up number 8, Gerardo Virial. We are calling that last one a hit. I think they just got lost in the lights.
Right. Never touched it.
Never touched it, so that is a hit for Laredo. 1-1 count, 2 outs. Runner on second base now after that blooper pop fly that he just had. Harrison settling down, checking the runner at second. There's the pitch. Hard hit ball to left field. Left fielder gets underneath it for the third out. After 2.5 innings of play, your score now is Laredo 4, Germany 2. Laredo right now has 6 hits with no errors. Germany goes 2 runs, 3 hits, 1 error going into the bottom half of the third inning.
And, you know, I don't think this is a typical game for Germany. They don't really play like this. It's looking a little sloppy, but give credit where credit is due. Laredo is putting the ball in play. They're swinging the bat. They're running the bases hard. They're doing what they have to do to stay with this Germany team. Harrison on the mound, he's actually pitching well. He's actually getting the pop flies. He's doing his part. And if it wasn't for the catcher and the second baseman making some good throws to get some runners out, be a different story. But so credit the defense that slightly helping him out. But I don't think there's any need to panic. All they have to do is keep plugging away, keep playing, keep plugging away. Once again, you're playing the host team that's used to this field, know how the bunts are laid out, know how the lights are here. All those things are the things that Germany's battling with, because this is not their field and this is their first time playing here.
And, you know, we did see that earlier in the second inning. You know, Laredo gets those two runs. Germany comes right back at the bottom half of the inning, manufactured their two runs. You know, this could just be a back-and-forth game now.
It can.
I was hoping that Harrison would settle down just a little bit. You know, and he is pitching good. He's getting what he needs to get. His defense is backing him up. There was a couple of, you know, couple of mistakes there that we can call them that happened.
I agree with you. And Hernandez, just right now during warm-ups, was warming up from the stretch. So he recognizes that's something that he has to work on, his pitching from the stretch. So I don't know if he just wanted to get on the mound and get a feel on the mound where his foot's going to land or something, but he definitely lost velocity once he switched over to the stretch.
Next up for Germany is number 10, Bedlin. Sorry about that. We have someone in front of the camera there.
That's not us.
That's not that. I do not look like that. No. I have to run them away from our camera. There's a windup and the pitch. Ball's in the dirt for ball number one. Going to give him a new ball there to keep going on. One of those account. Bottom half of the third. There's a pitch. Gets a hold of it, little chopper over to the third baseline. Foul ball. 1-1's now the count for Bedlin. There's the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss. He was swinging low on that one. He went all the way down to one knee on that one. A little bit in the dirt.
He was just way ahead of that pitch, and he couldn't hold back the bat, so.
Our statistician is leaving for the day. He had a long day. He was two blowout tires going to San Antonio, so now he says he's going home. He's done. He doesn't want to work with us anymore.
He's
going to
start
today.
Over again. He's just going to go home.
Reset his day.
Yeah.
1-2 is the count now here in Bedlin. Nobody on, nobody out. Bottom half of the third inning for Germany. There's the windup and the pitch. Ball's in the dirt. 2-2's the count.
You know, that ball in the dirt is strategic. He meant to put it in the dirt. A lot of pitchers do that. The catcher's back there trying his best to block that ball, but no can do.
There's the windup and the pitch. Nice hit ball out to shallow left center. Center fielder has no problems getting underneath that one.
Once again, the balls die here. If you're going to get a... really has to put some muscle into it.
Next up to bat is number 95, Lucas Ramaman. There's a windup and the pitch. Just high. One of those account, one out and nobody on. There's the pitch. Swing and a miss for strike number one. Pitcher settling in, doesn't like that one, doesn't like that one, gets the call that he likes. Here's the pitch. Big swing and a miss for strike number two now on Randleman.
You could just see the difference in none of this. Just a different pitcher when he's in the windup.
Shaking off a couple of pitches. I think he's got the right one. I think it's a fastball. There it is. Woo! Just a little bit inside. 2-2 is the count.
This is where Hernandez has to keep his composure. You know, he didn't like the call, but, you know, he looks up, he shakes his head, he comes off the mound. You know, you got to stay focused. You got to get ready for that next pitch.
There's the windup and the pitch. Full count now on the batter. One out. Bottom half of the third inning. There's the windup and the pitch. Batter stays away from that one. He works himself into a walk.
And there is where you see the pitcher lost his composure. He broke down and he lost the batter. But give credit to the batter. He stayed in there. He didn't just swing at everything.
Next up, we have number 31, Simon Bomber. Now, Simon started this off the last inning. He started the rally off there for Germany. Let's see what happens right now. There's the windup. Checks the runner to first. Runner's going. There goes the throw. Not in time. Safe at second base.
That was a nice steal. Nice jump. Got a good jump. That was a nice throw. A little high, but there was no way he was going to beat that jump.
And that number 95, Ramaman, has some speed on him. He got a real good jump, and he got down there in a hurry. 2-0 is now the count on the batter after that last pitch ball. Runners at second base in scoring position. If he gets one into the outfield, into the gaps, that runner is coming in.
Yeah, he's looking for something on the inside of the plate, something that he could drive to right field.
Checking the runner. There's the pitch. Swing and it fouls it back to the net. I think that's that pitch he was looking for.
Oh, yeah. You know, when a batter turns around looking down, you know he's saying to himself, God, that was the one. That's the one I wanted.
That was a nice pitch. Here it goes, 2-1 count. Runner on second base, one out now for Germany. Pitcher checks the runner over at second base. There's the pitch. There's that little looper into shallow center field. Holding up the runner. Beautiful throw down here by the center fielder. Able to stop it back there with the pitcher. Runners now on the corner for Germany with one out.
But nice hitting right there. You know, nice, beautiful swing. Hits the ball. He didn't really pull it. It went into center field. But the runner did his part by getting to second base on the steal so he can get over to third. So now they have runners on first and third with one out. And looks like Germany's back at it.
Next up is number one, Ian Eberhard. Pitcher's checking the runners. Gets the call. There's the pitch. Big swing and a miss. Strike number one.
We'll see if the runner's going on this pitch here.
Checks the runner at first. There's the pitch. Another big cut there for Eberhard. Strike number two. Looks like he might be just behind that pitch, just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
I mean, he is swinging for the fences, I think, on that one. He wants to get something out there, manufacture another run for Germany. And there's the pitch. Didn't swing on that one, giving a 1-2 count now with one out. Runners on the corner for Germany in a 4-2 game. Laredo leading right now in the bottom half of the third inning. There's the windup and the pitch. High pop fly. Third baseman looking at trying to track it down in the foul territory. And it's an out. Number 12 comes down with it. That's Sergio Galvan for the second out for Germany. Next up to bat for Germany is number 24, Zan Primoks. Primozik. Runners on the corner, two out now for Germany. Germany threatened here in the bottom half of the third inning. There's the pitch. Big swing and a miss, strike number one.
Now this is when you start thinking about that runner on first base. If they should have, maybe he's not fast enough. They don't want to, you know, put him in a situation where he gets thrown at second. But now Laredo has a chance. Any ball hit up the middle, they can go to second on a force out.
It is a ball number one. One and one's the count. Two outs. Runners on the corner for Germany. It did look like he was leading off just a little bit. Simon, you know, led off a little bit. Looked like he did want to run. Not sure what's going to happen here. Runner, the pitcher checks him over at first base, making sure to keep him honest. There's the pitch. Ball's in the dirt. Gets away from the catcher. One run scores. Simon round second base. Slows down there at second. Holds him up at second base.
What a break for Germany to get that pass ball.
Yeah, the ball came in, bounced off the dirt, flew back to the net. Catcher didn't know where it was at. I think, you know, if Simon would have been on that, on a steal on that one, he could actually have ended up at third base.
You're right, you're right. You're right, but, you know, what a break. Now they advance the runner, probably not their fastest runner. They advance him. They get out of that four situation.
That's a foul ball to the net. 2-2 is the count now on number 24. 2-2, two outs, runner on second base. Germany did score one run on that pass ball. Pitcher settling down. Shakes off a couple of calls from the catcher there. There's the pitch. Ball's in the dirt. There goes Simon trotting down the third baseline. Now we've had two pass balls already on this one player alone right now. That's able Simon to advance from first to second, now second to third, putting him in better scoring position. A little blooper to the outfield will get him in.
A little blooper gets him in, but I don't know if there's a cross-up between the catcher and the pitcher, but the catcher's tried to backhand a couple of balls that he's missed. He hasn't adjusted over. Maybe he was looking for fastball, a curve was thrown. I don't know what the cross-up is, but two pass balls, that's very rare.
There's a nice hit over to the shortstop. Shortstop cleans, fields it cleanly. Over to first base, it's bobbled!
There's the lack of intensity from the shortstop. You know, he picks up the ball. Runner is going down fast. I mean, he's fast. He's running fast. He's coming down. The shortstop needs to come in hard and make the throw to first. Instead, he kind of came up slow, threw the ball, and then when he saw the runner was running fast, he tried to overthrow. It goes into the dirt. Runner safe. Another run scores for Germany. We have a tie score 4-4.
Yeah, that was a nice hit to the shortstop. Like you said, he filled it cleanly.
He did.
But that throw that he had down the first baseline was a little off, causing the first baseman to come off the base. He had to dig it out of the dirt to save that runner from going anywhere else, enabling the runner to be safe at first base, where Laredo could have been coming off the field right now. Now they're stuck with another batter. Simon scores from third base after the two pass balls to get them from first to runner. And now we have a tied ball game. Next up for Germany is number 8. Von Kapp. Throws it back to first base to keep him honest. Coach did come out and talk to him a little while ago also, just to kind of settle him down. Say, hey, you know, relax, buddy. We got this. There's the pitch. Got a nice strike in there on that first pitch.
You know, I think anybody would tell you, if you don't know the runner, you don't know the batter and how he runs, play it fast. Play it fast and get the out. Don't play it slow, thinking that he's slow, and then find out as you're throwing the ball that he's fast.
Nice hit over to the third baseman. Third baseman comes in, works it out, fields it cleanly over to first. Out number three. But damage was done.
Damage was done, and we go back to how was damage done? Taking advantage of errors, taking advantage of just not heads-up baseball.
That's right. You know, again, second inning, Laredo scores two, Germany scores two. Mm-hmm. Third inning, Laredo scores two, Germany scores two also. Right. We're back to a 4-4 ball game. After three complete innings of play here at Uni-Trade Stadium, your score is now Laredo 4, Germany 4. Laredo has 6 hits on 1 error, and they got Germany has 4 runs on 4 hits and 1 error. Looks like we got a new pitcher coming in for Germany. Number 23, Jonathan Weyer, is now the pitcher for Germany. Again, we'd like to thank everybody out there that's listening to us today here at the from Uni-Trade Stadium for our broadcast of the Pony League World Series 2019 for the Palomino World Series Championship Games. This is our fourth game of today for today's bracket run. I've had the honor and pleasure to be calling all of the games today with my buddy Orly Navarro, and it's been a great tournament so far here in Laredo. And if anybody's watching and listening to us out there, send us a comment, send us a message. We'll give a shout out to you guys or answer any questions that you might have on what's going on out here or anything else, anything about Laredo.
That's right. The last game that we were broadcasting, we had a lot of people asking about Laredo, asking about the stadium, wanting to know a little bit about where is Laredo. And so we tried to oblige them with as much information as we knew. And
as we found out, we didn't know too much.
Yeah, we didn't know too much. We kind of didn't get it right. But nevertheless, then at 6 o'clock, you were master of ceremonies for the opening ceremony that we had on the field. That was very nice. We had some of our Pony League special needs kids that led the parade, so they were excited to do that. They also helped out with the first pitch. And then, of course, we had the parade of teams. The Bronco 12 and under teams were here, and then plus the Palomino teams. They did their little parade around the infield. We had some speeches from different city officials that came out. Some of the Pony League officials that are here, the CEO of Pony here in town today. This city is putting on 2 World Series at the same time this weekend. It has never been done in the last 60 years of Pony's existence. We've never had a city that hosted 2 World Series at one time. Laredo's doing that for the first time this weekend.
And up to bat for Laredo is number 4, Jerry Campos. Yagario Campos, I'm sorry. You got 2 strikes on Mr. Campos now. But yeah, Laredo, this is the first time in any city that they've hosted 2 World Series simultaneously. Also, we had one of our guest speakers today was also our state representative, Henry Cuellar, came out and cheered everybody on.
U.S. representative.
U.S. representative. I'm sorry, U.S. representative. I said state representative. Yeah. I'm sorry. I apologize, Mr. Cuellar, on that. 1-2 is the count now. That ball's in the dirt. 2-2 now. Yeah, he came out and said some real nice words and words of encouragement to everybody and welcome all the different teams, our team from Germany, our teams from Chinese Taipei, welcome them in their language, right. and Puerto Rico also, welcome all of them in their language. There's a nice chopper over to third baseman fields it cleanly over to first base. First baseman digs it out, he's out for out number 1.
That's how you make a play happen. You know, third baseman didn't hesitate, came in, make that throw, nice scoop at first base. But that's how you play it. You know, you got to play it fast because you don't know what kind of runner's going down the field. But excellent play by the third baseman.
Next up for Laredo is number 13, Eric Garcia. You know, just in case my daughter's still listening, Katie, I love you. Get to bed because we got an early day tomorrow. I'm hoping she's already asleep.
It's only 9 o'clock. Come on, man.
She's only 6.
Go to bed.
Well, when we were in Disney a couple of weeks back, yeah, it was long days. And yeah. She was rocking and rolling every single day. It was awesome. Anyways, back to the game. I apologize for that. 1-0 is the count right now on number 13, Garcia. There's the pitch. A little bit low there. for ball number two. As we said, on the mound right now for Germany is number 23, Jonathan Weyer. Replacing, was it Harrison, correct? And they're replacing yes. Patrick Harrison. A little bit low, ball three. Now, that could be a strategy. It could be, you know, Harrison's their ace pitcher. Let's let him pitch a couple of innings to get used to it. Let's take him out so we can save him for a game. Maybe tomorrow he can pitch in as relief or the next day.
I just don't see, maybe the pitch count was more than they wanted to after three innings. Maybe this was already in the books. They were going to bring in a pitcher. Let him only pitch three innings. But Harrison wasn't doing that bad a job. He was actually, you know, around the plate doing a good job. Weyer's here needs to warm up. He has to figure out the mound. I've noticed a couple of times he's gone to kick the hole around to try to adjust it for him. So you're right. It could be strategy.
It's a ball four walk there for number 13, Garcia. Now, yeah, we've been talking about pitch counts all day long. Finally got a book here in front of me. The age range from 17 to 18, their daily max pitch count is 105. Okay, that's their daily max. If they go to 30 pitches, they don't have to have a day of rest. 31 to 45 pitches, that's one day of rest. 45 to 60, they got to have 2 days. For 3 days, 61 to 80, and 81 plus, that's 5 days of rest. So it could have been that. They could have been seeing how close he was to that pitch count and said, you know what, we're going to sit you down, we're going to take a little break, and there we go. Next up to bat for Laredo is number six, Joel Hinojosa, with a runner on first base with one out. There's the pitch. A little bit in the dirt. It looks like he's still trying to settle in, Mr. Weyer there, trying to settle in to the mound. Now, as we've seen in the past couple of innings from Laredo, they've taken advantage and they've stolen second base a couple of times already. So I wonder if that's going to be their same strategy here. It does take a nice little leadoff. There's the pitch. There's that first called strike. But looks like Hinojosa was squaring around there to bunt, bringing in that third baseman down the line. One and two is the count. One out on Hinojosa. There's the pitch. A shot right between the first and second baseman into the gap. The right fielder comes in, fields it cleanly, holds everybody at bay.
Oh, that's right. No one's going to run on that arm. Did you see that throw from the right fielder? He got it in quick on a line. Laredo has a runner on first and second.
Yeah, out there in right field is number 95, it looks like. Ramaman. So he's got a cannon there. He brought that one in nicely.
But, you know, the pitcher's got to work on his counts. You know, with two strikes, you just don't give up something that easy to hit.
Runners at first and second for our batter here from Laredo. There's the windup and the pitch just high. High and inside. Ball number one. Our batter right now is number three, Alan Vidal for Laredo. Catcher stepping out to give signs over to the pitcher and to the team, letting them know what we got lined up here.
You know, this is where the first baseman, third baseman should be looking at the coach to decide where are you going to play, simply because he could lay down another bunt.
There's a windup. Strike on that one. One and one's a count. You know, just as you said, he could lay down another bunt. It looked like he was getting ready to.
It looks like his hands were shifting to do that. And I think he sees that the corners are back.
Here's the windup. We got a balk call on that one. It's going to advance all the runners.
Didn't look like the pitcher stopped.
So one and one's a count, one out, runners advance on the balk.
The infield's playing in, everybody's playing in.
Just high, two and one's a count. 2-1, one out, runners on second and third base. There's the pitch. Bounces in, but that's what we talked about earlier, about not trying to scoop it. That catcher gets in front of that ball to stop it and block it and keep it in front of him.
Right, and did you see the pitcher's reaction? He was so happy that he blocked the ball. You know, that's just confidence that you're giving your pitcher.
3-1's a count. There's the pitch. Swings, and it's a foul ball over here to the third baseline. Full count now on the batter, number 3, Alan Villar. Full count, one out, two men on, second and third. Batter's back in the batter's box. Catcher's calling in the signal. Shakes him off once, and here goes the pitch. There's the pitch.
Ball four.
Ball four, just high. Loading the bases now for Laredo. Bringing up number 14, Nomar Garcia.
You know, just when you're looking at the situation and you're saying to yourself, okay, Laredo's put Germany in a situation where they have to play in, play the grounder, hold the runner, throw the first. That walk changes everything. Now bases are loaded. All the players are playing back now. And now there's more pressure on the pitcher to get that ground ball, to pitch that pitch, to get the ground ball, to hopefully turn two. But the infield, the shortstop, second baseman playing back, double play depth, the corners are in.
There's a windup and a pitch. Big swing and a miss for strike number one. I think that's what he needed, that strike. He needed that confidence.
He does.
Confident builder. If we look out there to the right field sign under above the HEB sign, we do have somebody already in the bullpen out there for Germany.
Right.
That's a ball number two. 2-1's the count. One out. Runners all around. Bases are loaded in the top half of the fourth inning here for Laredo. There's the windup and the pitch. Big cut sends it foul.
Gotta love the fans, everybody chasing after the foul ball.
2-2 is the count now. One out, bases loaded for number 14, Garcia. Pitcher settling in, there's the windup and the pitch. Bringing the count to full, full count now. All right, full count, one out, bases loaded. A nice hit over to the left fielder comes in, fields it cleanly, bringing in a nice throw, holding the runners at bay.
Nice play by the left fielder.
That's number one, it looked like. Number one, Eberhardt, beautiful. He ran in on that fly ball, catches it cleanly, and just has a cannon to throw it to the cutoff man at third base. Runner couldn't move.
And that's the play. You know, you're the outfielder. Get it to the cutoff. He did it. He executed perfectly. And you could see none of the runners moved. Everybody stayed because that ball was thrown perfectly. If he overthrows the cutoff man, it goes to the catcher. Then you have a different situation. Could get bobbled or whatever. But Germany executed that play properly. That held everybody. They were able to get an extra out. Now bases loaded with two outs. Here comes the coach. He's talking to his pitcher, trying to pump him up. You can do this. Keep the ball down. Let's get the grounder. Grounder, we can go to any base. Let's get out of this inning.
All right, here we go. Wires getting ready. Number 12 now for Laredo up to bat. That's Sergio Galvan. That's a first called strike there on Mr. Garvan.
This is where Germany has to concentrate. This is the number 3 batter with the number 4 batter coming up with bases loaded.
One and one's the count on Mr. Galvan. Bases loaded, two outs. They say our radar gun is working. That's what I'm understanding, right?
Yes.
That looked like an 84 mile an hour pitch, if I'm not mistaken. There's a windup. Can't really tell what that one said on that one, but nice slow one that came in there. Ball number three. Three and one's the count for Galvan. Bases loaded.
I think you're going to see Galvan. Galvan has the green light to adjust on a 3-1.
There's the pitch. Foul ball to the right side of the field.
This would be a huge boost for Germany to get this out right here with bases loaded. This is definitely what if you want to pick me up, this is it right here. You have the best batter, in my opinion, on this Laredo team, followed by the second best batter, and bases loaded, and you're able to get that out. That says a lot. I think a baseball was thrown back into the field. The umpires are reviewing something. I think there's some distraction in the stands.
They're asking for a ruling on something here. We got a little break in the action. They're asking for a ruling on something. Looks like there might have been a baseball thrown back in. They're pointing to the person maybe that threw the ball back in. It was a foul ball that was in the non-field of play, and looks like they might have just thrown it back in.
No, what I think happened was somebody is shining something, not necessarily at the field. They just had something shiny. So the umpire at second base picked it up, and they were asking whatever it was that they had in their hand to just turn it off.
All right, here we go. Getting ready to get back to play. It's a full count, two outs. Bases loaded for number 12, Sergio Galvan. Pitcher settling in. Throws it over to third base. Arid throw on that one. The third baseman wasn't waiting for it at all. One run scores. Runners advance to second and third now. I think they were going for a pickoff play there, but I don't think the third baseman was in line with it.
I think you're right. A 3-2 pitch, and the pitcher lobs it over to the third baseman who wasn't even paying attention, and the ball just kind of went right past him. That scores a run. So Laredo catches a break.
That's called interference.
That hit the catcher's glove.
Sending everybody back to where they're at.
That was obvious. Let's see if the catcher's okay. As soon as the ball was hit, the glove popped off and the catcher was checking his hand. Now the coach is out there checking. So that puts Galvan at first base. That was a 3-2 pitch.
He did swing at it. He did get a hold of it. It rolled out.
But how about that play? You know, that play to third base. I want to say that play comes from the dugout. I just can't see where the pitcher would just do that without letting the third baseman know. But somewhere in there was a miscommunication. and Laredo caught a break and were able to score a run. But that was just an odd play.
That was an odd play. It could have been something they were talking about. He did see the runner leading off. Maybe the third baseman didn't catch that leadoff as much. He was concentrating more on the batter. And so the ball gets thrown over to third base, gets into the fence, lets that runner come in. Now we're back up to number 15, Francisco Hernandez for Laredo. Bases loaded after that interference called by the catcher. Two outs. We still have bases loaded, two outs. One ball now on the batter. There's the windup. And the pitch. Hard hit ball to left field. Foul ball. That was a nice hit ball down the line.
Yeah.
Tell you what, if that one stayed in, I'm looking probably about two more runs coming in for Laredo on that one.
Yep, and Galvan on first is a speedster. Any error on any throw or cutoff or something like that, you'd see him come also.
All right, here we go. 1-1's the count. There's the pitch. Strike number 2, 1-2.
That was a nice bender there. That kept Hernandez off. You know, he thought he was going to see something a little bit faster. And Wire gets himself out of the inning on that strikeout.
That's strike number three on the batter. You know, Laredo had many opportunities that inning to manufacture a little more runs. Germany got lucky. Well, they made a mistake to bring that run in, but they did get lucky that there wasn't more runs that came out.
Absolutely. You know, that right now, Laredo's in this game, and I'll repeat this. Laredo's host is a host team. So it's a select group that plays in this. This is not a team that went through tournaments and won a championship to be here. Germany is a team that won their championship, and they're here because they're champions of their area. So theoretically, Laredo shouldn't even be on the field competing with these guys. And I think it's just Germany has been giving away too many breaks, and it's keeping Laredo in the game. At some point, Germany has to eliminate that stuff.
Yes.
You know? That's the problem here. Germany needs to eliminate that stuff, start focusing on hitting the ball, making the routine plays, and eliminate some of that mental mistakes. Even, you know, the catcher interfering with the batter. Yeah, he didn't mean to do that. But that stuff that just adds on, that's the frustration to the coach for Germany, that Laredo's not really bombarding Germany to where they should be up 5-4. It shouldn't be like that. So Germany's going to have to figure out something in that dugout to get back on course, get back to what they do best, because if not, Laredo's going to stay with them, and we're getting into the fourth inning. It's the middle of the inning of the game, and that's when you better start buckling down, because you won't have that many more outs to try to beat Laredo.
Yeah, and that's true. It's very true what you're saying there, Orly. A couple of mental errors out on the field, especially that one that brought in that run for Laredo. Now let's see what happens. You know, bottom of the second inning, Germany scores 2. Bottom of the third inning, top of the third, Laredo scores 2, Germany scores 2. Now right now, Laredo scores 1. Let's see what happens to Germany. Now, looking at our posts here on YouTube, thank you for the awesome commentary. Keep it up. Thank you very much for that. We are trying our best. This is our fourth game today, so if our voices go in and out a little bit, we do apologize. I did have to do the opening ceremony also. Big swing and a miss for number nine, Kirchhoff up to bat for Germany. 1-1's the count now. Foul ball, 1-2. So we've been working pretty much all day long since 8 o'clock this morning. Again, this is our fourth game. We did the ceremony to call everybody in. So we're a little tired. But yeah, I'm seeing here also, thank you very much for the lovely comments. Swing and a miss for strike number three. Thank you very much for the lovely comments. We do appreciate it. We really do. And I see here that my wife is online. She's watching the game now.
Uh-oh.
She said to say hi. So I'm saying, hi, I love you guys. Thank you very much. Orly says hi. And Katie, we love you. You don't be giving mommy any hassles. And I hope you're getting ready for bed in a little bit. Up next for Germany is number four, Vaukler. He had a little check swing that ended up going into their own dugout for a foul ball. Bunts it down towards the pitcher. Pitcher fields it cleanly over to first base, out number one. You know, I think they're still trying to figure out the field, so to speak, because each bunt they've done has gone straight back to the pitcher.
Right, right. They haven't been able to get it to right or left. It's just going back to the pitcher. That's a frustration because it was a good play. To bunt the ball down, no one was ready for it. It just happened to go straight back to the pitcher. If he gets it down the third baseline or first baseline, he has a base hit.
Number five.
So, you know, I just got a text message from my daughter. It says, I can hear you, Daddy. So I think we're doing a good job. If my little one says she can hear us, we're doing a good job. Thank you, sweetie. I love you. Next up for Germany is number five, Sandbergson. We got one ball, no strikes, two outs here in the bottom half of the fourth inning. Call it strike number one, 1-1 now on the batter. Pitcher settling in. There's the windup and the pitch. Bunts it down towards the first base line. He's moving fast. Out of there. A bang, bang play. Yeah, that was a beautiful bunt because he bunted it the right direction.
That was a beautiful bunt. That was a fast runner. That was just an exceptional play by the pitcher to get off the mound, hustle to the ball, and throw a shot to first base. It was a bang, bang play. First baseman doing a great job to give him some space to the side, to give him a target to throw at. But that was one of those plays that if you don't do it perfect, you're safe at first.
Yes, yeah, and it was very, very close. Now here we go. After four complete innings of play here at Uni-Trade Stadium, Laredo, 5 runs on 7 hits with 1 error. Germany, 4 runs on 4 hits with 2 errors. So our score stands, Laredo 5, Germany 4, going into the top half of the fifth inning. Now remember, this is Pony League play, 18 and under. They play 7 innings.
That's right.
You got 3, 6, 9 more outs for Germany here to manufacture some runs, and for Laredo to manufacture some runs to maybe add on to their lead.
Well, Germany did not need to have a quick inning right there. They were able to allow the Laredo pitcher to get some rest. He went out there. He didn't throw very many pitches, and he's back in the dugout. Plus, you had that long inning with the bases loaded and everything. So the Laredo pitcher has been in that dugout sitting down. He's had a chance to relax and rest, whereas Germany on the flip side have been on the field more. And that just with the heat that we have here in Laredo and just the amount of pitches that are being thrown, it can impact your pitcher.
Yeah, we're going back here to our YouTube page here. Carla Berryman, her husband's a home plate umpire.
Oh,
and she's saying thank you very much for broadcasting the game so she can see her husband work. Her hubby working.
Absolutely. And you know what? All day, we haven't mentioned the umpires.
No,
that's a good thing.
That's a very good thing.
He's calling
an exceptional game here today. As a matter of fact, the umpires all day long have been calling a great game here today. They've stuck to their strike zones, and they're being honest with everything they're doing because they're sharing it on both sides.
And they're hustling. They're getting to the position to make their calls and stuff. Like, I'm going to knock on wood because we don't want to, you know, we don't want to jinx them. But they've been all day. We haven't had to talk about it.
And there's that first call strike on the batter. Looks like it's number 18. Number 16, I'm sorry. That is Mr. Eric Reese.
You know, now that we have the wife listening, I wonder if an umpire ever gets in front of the mirror, you know, because this umpire has some swag when he calls a strike, you know, so I don't know if he stands in front of the mirror and practices. I wonder if she could let us know.
Hey, Carla, that's a good question for you. Do you ever catch your hubby?
Get some insight.
In front of the mirror, practicing his strike call. There's a nice hit over to the first baseline. Just swinging foul for Mr. Reese there. Yes, they are. They are all great guys, Carla. They are great guys. I got to see a couple of them here earlier as they were sitting down having their chow, getting ready for their last game here of the day. But let me know, Carla. We want the inside information from the inside source.
Yeah.
We're like inquiring minds. That's ball number one. 1-2 is the count now on the batter. No outs here, top of the fifth inning. Here from Uni-Trade Stadium in Laredo, Texas. There's the windup and the pitch. Just a little bit out of the zone there. 2-2 now is the count. Next up to bat for Laredo will be number 8, Gerardo Villal. There's the windup and the pitch. Nice hard hit. Ball over to the first baseman. Cleans it freely. Tells the pitcher, stay back. I got this, brother. Out number one.
Nice, smooth play by the first baseman.
He was able to field that real cleanly.
Yeah, you're not going to get a bad bounce here. With this artificial turf, you know, there's really no bad bounces. You just have to get down and block the ball. That's exactly what he did.
So here's a little bit of inside information that Carla's letting us know.
Here we go.
He does ask her to take pictures of them, and they can critique each other.
Oh.
So number 8 is in the batter's box right now. That is Gerardo Villal takes the first ball, first pitch ball. Carla says she hasn't seen him in the mirror, but he has been to many training clinics. I guess that's where they get it at. I think we're going to have to sneak a camera in next time he goes to the training clinic.
I can see him at those clinics in one of those dance rooms, you know, where the dancers practice.
Oh, yeah,
the big
dance
mirror,
studios,
you know,
the mirrors,
the
yeah.
And they're all in there and they're doing strike.
Yeah,
and
there you go.
Ball,
yeah,
strike. Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, we've both played baseball many years, and I remember back in the day we had an umpire. Loved this guy to death. That's a hard hit ball over to the shortstop. Shortstop picks it up, throws it over to first just in time. Out number 2. Next up is number 4, Mr. Campos. So, yeah, I remember this umpire. He was great, his greatest umpire. He would come out and actually coach us during the game. He would help the batters out, mm-hmm. help the pitchers out, coach, which is what it should be in Little League, right? But my favorite time was when somebody would strike out. Because he would get down, and he'd turn a little bit, and it was shimmy-dimmy-doo. That was the strikeout call for him. It was awesome. Just those little memories.
Yeah, no, I don't think we're going to see that here.
No, I don't think it's a shooby-dooby-doo here.
No, not here.
Yeah, and I hope it's not like, what was that, Naked Gun 21 and a half? Yeah. He was out there umpiring also. So next up, we got number 4, Mr. Campos. 1 ball, no strikes, 2 outs.
You know, with that play at first base and the shortstop making the play, you see Germany starting to play a little bit better. Let's see if they can get out of this inning. They need to get out of this inning. They got to get some runs scored. So this is where they have to buckle down and shut down Laredo.
We have a weather update. Yeah, as we've been talking about how hot it is here in Laredo. Right now we got 3 balls, no strikes on the batter. It's 95 degrees as of 9:30. It's 95 degrees here in Laredo. Feels like 100 though.
Yeah.
So I think we've hit a little cold spell. We've been in the 106s all day long, and now we're in our cold spell. We're at 100. Campos gets on 4 balls there, walks over to first base. 2 outs, runner on first base.
Catcher's walked out to the mound, talking to the pitcher. Don't overdo it. Just pitch your game. You don't have to do it all yourself. You have your team behind you. And then you see him kind of point at the shortstop to let him know, that's who you're going with, you know. When you if you have to go to second base, you just a little bit of communication, just to relax the pitcher, you know, just trying to get him to focus back on what he has to do, and that's pitch strikes.
Yeah. Next up for Laredo is number 13, Eric Garcia. We've been going back and forth with Carla, and now Tamara Fontaine is also letting us know a little bit about umpiring here. Umpires work hard on the field and train hard. They live, eat, and breathe baseball during the season. And I'm guessing her husband is Brent. That's the way he lives, eats, and breathes. Carla You guys are funny and doing a great job.
Thank you very much.
And yes, Carla said there will be no shooby dooby doo from the umpires today. Keeping the runner honest at first base, throwing it back there to chase him back to the base. Number 13, Eric Garcia at the plate. 1-1, 2 outs. Runner at first base. Wire still on the mound for Germany. There's the pitch. Pop fly to shallow right field. Second baseman working his way back through the lights. Catches the ball. Out number 3 in that inning. That pitch looked up about an 86-mile-an-hour pitch, according to a radar gun.
Yeah, that radar gun says he threw an 86, but he's been able to even drop down to 60. That's a huge difference. You know, sometimes you don't even have to throw a curveball or a slider or anything like that. If you could just change up your speeds, that alone throws some batters off, you know, just on the speed. So that's pretty amazing that he could drop, you know, 20 miles on a pitch and throw it for a strike or get somebody to pop out. So that's pretty amazing.
You know, that is amazing. That 60-mile-an-hour pitch, that's my fastball.
Yeah.
That's my fastball. Oh, now they got some Sweet Caroline playing here in Laredo. You know, what's the stadium that does this song in the major leagues where everybody sings along?
New York? Oh, I don't know.
Is it Chicago? Does Chicago do this?
I don't know.
I can't remember which major league. If someone knows, let me know because I like this one. Because everybody sings along to it.
I want to know where these umpires are from.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Carla and Tamara, where are y'all from? Where are the umpires from?
Yep, people are dancing.
Up and dancing. You got to dance to this song because it's so good, so good.
Oh. We've got a lot of baseball coming up tomorrow. We'll be here all day. Same thing. We're going to be here till 9 o'clock. Earlier today, we have some scores. Youngstown, Ohio beat Mazatlan, Mexico 10-0. In the second game, Harlingen, Texas, representing the South Zone, beat Aroma Park, Illinois, 2-0.
Okay. Boston Red Sox. They do it in Boston, the Bean Town. Okay. Boston. Sweet Caroline. Thank you, Carla. Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry, Rory.
We also
Puerto Rico won that one. That was a close game also.
Puerto Rico won the third game, and then, of course, we have tonight's game. So the teams that we have not seen play yet, Santa Clara, the Red Sox from California, they have yet to play. They play tomorrow at 11:30. They'll be playing Youngstown, Ohio. Also, Chinese Taipei, they're here in town. They have yet to play a game yet. They'll face Harlingen tomorrow. So we'll get to see them. So the excitement continues for us here in Laredo to see these out-of-town teams. The hype has been going on for months that we're going to have the World Series. We're finding out little by little. We find out Germany won, that they're coming. We find out that Taiwan won, and they're coming. But we have yet to see them play. Santa Clara goes out and beats Los Angeles, which Los Angeles came here last year. So now we're excited to see them play. So we don't get to see them till tomorrow. But exciting baseball happening here. This is a baseball town. People love it. We have the 12-year-old Bronco division. They're playing in our Benavides complex. It's in south from here. And so they have games going on over there. So it's just going to be a full weekend of baseball.
Next up to bat for Germany is number 10, Benden. He's fouled two off so far. 0-2 count on Benden. We were asking where the officials are from.
Yeah.
They're from the San Antonio Bush Country chapter. So
oh,
right
nice.
Up the street, 150 miles away from us.
Right.
So yeah, the wives aren't too far away. So they might want to come down on the weekend, do a little shopping here in Laredo.
They probably know Laredo, you know?
Yeah, they probably know Laredo. Come down, do a little shopping, spend a little bit of the money that maybe they're earning if they're getting paid. I don't know.
Don't go there. Umpires never get paid enough.
They never do, but the wives can still spend the money.
My wife's a teacher. Teachers never get paid enough. You know, umpires
and
same
your wife's way. An excellent singer, too.
Thank you.
She's an excellent singer. Now, I've heard Orly sing.
No.
I mean, we don't want to go there. No. But his wife is a wonderful, wonderful singer. She sings for one of our local acts bands at her church for one of our retreats.
Yes, she
so
does.
So she sings there as part of their bands, and they're excellent, excellent
That's right.
singers.
All I do is carry in the equipment, set it up, put it back in the truck, get it to the house, unload. That's my role.
The roadie. Here we go. We got one ball, two strikes on the batter. I'm like Brush Country Chapter. I'm sorry. Out of San Antonio. Strike number three with a big cut there on the batter. Sitting them back into the dugout.
Well, you know, Hernandez, I've had a chance to see him throughout this game. And when he is in a rhythm, he is just bringing it. And he loves to throw that fastball.
So next up is number 95, Rammerman. For Germany, he started off the last inning getting on base, and he was able to move around and manufacture a run there for Germany in the second inning. Holds on that one, 1-1's account, one out. It looks like that was like in the 80s, 86 mile an hour maybe fastball.
He's been flirting with 88, 89, 86. He's staying there. This is the fifth inning.
Ball was just a little bit high. 2-1's account. Still in the 80s.
5-4. Laredo leads Germany in the bottom of the fifth.
There it is. Strike number two. 2-2's account. One out. That looks like an 87 mile an hour ball there.
Well, the batter was trying to ask for a timeout. The umpire didn't give it to him.
There's the windup and the pitch. Sitting them down. Strikeout.
You know, everything that's happened, the last inning, remember, Hernandez didn't pitch that many pitches. And then the big inning by Laredo had him sitting down. It looks like he's fresh and he's gotten his, you know, he's got his second wind almost. And he's out there and he's throwing some fire.
Nice hard hit ball between the second and third third baseman and shortstop. That was number 31, Simon Bomber for Germany, getting on base. Beautiful hit on that one. Found the gap between the third and shortstop and just knocked it into the outfield.
He's having himself a game. You know, he's playing a complete game defensively, hitting the balls, keeping Germany in the game, you know, and trying to score some runs. Let's see what Germany could do with two outs. Remember, this is where the pitcher turns, and now he's in the stretch.
This is
where we've noticed that Germany's been able to take advantage of that.
So they're going to call a timeout here. Don't talk to the pitcher. The catcher's going up there. Germany's switching out some stuff. Carter says she typically does come to the games with her husband because she likes coming and watching baseball. But right now she's digging the air conditioning at home and enjoying chatting with us. No other way to enjoy baseball. No way to enjoy baseball, being at home, relaxing, in the air conditioning.
She's from San Antonio. She knows how hot it gets down here in Laredo.
Yeah, if somebody from Germany, from Paderborn, Germany, where this team's from, let me know, what's the average weather like, especially right around today? What's the average temperature out there in Germany?
I've only seen beautiful pictures of Germany. You know, they're postcard pictures of Germany. That's all I've seen.
Next up to bat for Germany is number one. This is Ebert Hart. Now, my brother was stationed in Germany for a time. He was in Frankfurt and Würzburg, Germany. He was out there for a while, about 4 years in the Army. It's really nice temperatures, cool temperatures in that area. Oh, looks like they changed the base runner. They had a pinch runner come in. Can't see his number, though. Is it number 25? Herwig? I want to his account on number one. Edinburgh. Runner stealing. There goes the throw into the outfield. Center fielder was able to gobble that up to save extra bases there.
Yeah, that was a strong throw by the catcher. If it's caught, I think they get the runner, but the runner did a great job of staying, sliding in and staying on the bag.
Here we go. Runner on second base. There's the pitch. Just high. 2-2 is the count. Two outs. Runner on second base. Looks like about 86 mile an hour pitch on that one. I do have a little bit of history of the Boston Red Sox in that song, by the way, so we'll talk about that in a minute because I do like that song. And there's the pitch. Just inside, turning the batter a little bit sideways. Bringing the count to full. Full count, two outs. Runner on second base. That one floated in about 83 miles an hour or so. Here's the pitcher. Checks the runner at second. There's the pitch. Big swing and a miss. Out number three. And just like that, Laredo stops the German run.
That really hurts. You put in a pinch runner. The pinch runner steals second base. So the pinch runner does it their job to get in scoring position with two outs. You're down by one. Just a ball put in play changes everything. That runner can get to third, potentially trying to stretch it home because of the speed. It ties up the game. What a big strikeout for Hernandez to keep Germany at bay.
All right, here's a little bit of history for the Boston Red Sox and why they play that song. This all happened in 1997. It started with a baby named Caroline.
Okay.
In 1997, during a game at Fenway, Amy Toby, who was one of the employees in charge of music at the ballpark, during that season played Sweet Caroline because someone she knew had recently given birth to a baby of that name. So it was a kind of a dedication to her friend.
And it just stuck.
Yeah, Toby became superstitious about it. It was used over the next several years, only playing the song between the 7th and 9th innings when the Red Sox were winning the game. So they only play between the 7th and 9th inning when the Sox are up. So there we go. Bit of useless trivia.
There you go.
You never know. It might come up. You might be at the bar playing trivia or something, and they might ask that. You never know. Could win some free wings or something.
He's on a roll. I'm just letting him run with it.
And of course, I get a message here also. You know, we're going back and forth on our message board. And my daughter, once again, she's watching the game now. Hi, Daddy, I love you. Smiley face, smiley face. I love that little one. She's crazy that way. Love you too, Katie. Here we are, back to action now. Number six for Laredo is up to bat, Joel Hinojosa. That pitch there by Wire was in the 70s, about 74 miles an hour. One ball, no strikes. Strike number one. All right, here we go. Currently in Germany right now, 60 degrees.
Oh, how nice.
60 degrees.
60 degrees.
And we're sitting at a nice 100 degrees. Beautiful shot. That the batter was jammed on that ball. He was able to get it in. Third baseman dives out for it, misses the ball, gets into left field. Now Hinojosa sitting at first base. There comes Laredo again.
Here comes Laredo again. Nice dive by the third baseman, just out of his reach. But now you're in a situation where what does Laredo do? They've stolen bases. They bunt the ball over. So now it changes things. Here comes the coach. He's going to come out and talk to his pitcher because Laredo has shown different things. You have to talk it over. You have to be prepared.
It looks like they're bringing in somebody from the bullpen. They did have somebody out there already warming up, so now right. Here comes somebody coming in. Tomorrow, thank you. Thank you. He says, we guys are pretty funny. We're just trying to bring as much information.
And we're trying to be
fun.
Serious.
We are serious. We're serious.
Of course
people.
We're serious. Yeah, we don't smile.
Yeah, we don't smile.
That's right.
We don't laugh.
No.
We're trying to bring as much information to keep you guys entertained watching this game and have fun with it, you know?
Right.
We've both played baseball in our younger days. No, we didn't go professional, but we do have some professional people from Laredo. We did talk about that earlier.
That's right.
In fact, we had one of our county judge who was here earlier for the ceremony. He played some good ball also.
Played
he,
for the Milwaukee Brewers.
Played yeah, for the Brewers.
Their organization.
That's he threw right. a nice fastball out there during the...
Well, yeah, they put the mayor to catch, and then they put the county judge to pitch.
Well, I'm going to tell you what happened there. Representative Cuellar got up there, got ready, starting to stretch out.
Yeah.
Grabbed the shoulder. Had to call in the righty.
Call in the righty.
And that's what happens, you know. And Thano came in, ready to go. He was already warmed up. Ran in from the bullpen, ready to throw it in there.
Yeah.
I feel bad for the mayor.
Our county judge is probably, 20 years younger than the mayor? So why couldn't they have the mayor throw to the county judge, not the county judge throw to the mayor? I mean, you know, he used to play Major League Baseball, and they put him on the mound. The mayor has readers on. You know, you can't – that was a dangerous situation. But, all right, you guys were the ones that were coordinating. I was just up here kind of observing.
I didn't coordinate anything. I was just holding the mic and passing baseballs.
Yeah, and dripping sweat.
It was a nice 106 at that time. And I come back up here, and my partner in crime, Orly, sitting here is like, man – I tell him, close the windows, it's hot. He goes, dude, it's a cool breeze.
It's a nice breeze.
I was whatever.
Okay. I didn't have to go down there.
And we did get a pitching change for Germany. Looks like it is number 44, if I'm not mistaken. It's 44. Luca.
Number 3.
Kopenberg. Lupa Kopenberg now on the mound for Germany. Number 3 for Laredo is Alan Vidal on the mound. Yeah, that is beautiful weather in Germany, 60 degrees.
Yeah.
I like that. Now here's the windup and the pitch. That ball came in at about 74 miles an hour, just a little bit low. 1-1's the count. Looks like Alan's trying to bunt the runner over, so the third baseman is cheating in a little bit. Watching for that bunt.
But the pitcher also has to come off that mound. He has to come off hard, just like Laredo does. Let's see if he jumps off the mound.
And he foul tipped that one for strike number 2. 1-2's the count now. That one came in at about 86 miles an hour. Just a little bit high now. 2-2 is the count. No outs. Runner on first base for Laredo. Checking the runner at first. And there's the pitch. Just a half-hearted swing there and fouled the ball off. Kind of saved himself on that one.
He did. He was just trying to protect himself.
That's right, Nicole. It's 96 degrees here in Laredo. Feels like 101. Here we go. 2-2. No outs. Runner on first base. Checks the runner at first. There's the pitch. Runner's going. Swing and a miss. Stolen base.
Stolen base. Germany gets the out.
Yeah, I think that probably was a hit and run situation for Laredo.
That's right.
He was able to get a good jump on that one. Able to get over to... the second base there, got the strikeout for Germany. Now we got one out. Runner at second base now in scoring position for Laredo. Next up for Laredo is number 14, Nomar Garcia. Just a bit high. Ball one.
That catcher is doing everything to catch that ball. You know, that ball was about 6 feet up in the air. He had to jump to get that.
Yeah, he is helping his pitcher today. All of his pitchers so far, he's helped him out. He's been able to block the balls, get in front of him. You know, a defensive catcher, very good defensive catcher. Very good defensive catcher, keeping him at bay. Here we go, 2 balls, no strikes, runner on second base, 1 out. Number 14, Nomar Garcia up at the plate. Foul ball, come right back at us. Yeah, we're kind of parked right by here behind the press box, and that ball came right at us.
Help me out here, but I'm looking at the dugout, and I see the little the little 12-year-old baseball players from Puerto Rico. That is Puerto Rico down there, isn't it? Right there. They're treating the Laredo team as if they're major leaguers. They're down there talking to them. I mean, that's stuff that's going on while the game's going on. All these little 12-year-old players are so excited to be able to talk to the 18-year-old players.
3-1's the count now. One out. Runner at second. Just high. Gives him a free base to first.
It could be Mexico.
Yeah, I think that is the Bronco League Mexico team down there talking with the Laredo squad. You know, and we said it earlier, you know, that's what I like about this. You know, international play, basically. Players from all around the world here, and they're treating each other like best friends. You know, earlier right. today when we were getting ready for the ceremony, they were all chanting all the Palomino League, we're all chanting, and everybody got together for a big group picture. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Next up for Laredo is number 12, Sergio Galvan. Runners at second and first. Nice hit to left field. Just swinging foul, though. Foul ball.
Yeah, you know, everybody else was, we have an agenda. We have to follow the agenda. We have to start at a certain time. Everybody forgot to tell the players. They were all hugging and all the teams got together for a giant group picture. They could care less that you guys had something to announce.
Yeah, they were kind of telling me, hey, we got to get started. I'm like, I can't do nothing because they're having fun.
That's right.
I'm not going to stop them. Not all these 18-year-olds are a little younger than me, and they could probably take me out. I'm just saying. 0-2 is the count on number 12, Galvan. Runners at first and second, one out for Laredo. That ball was just a little bit inside. 1-2 is the count. Looks like it was roughly around 84 miles an hour, give or take. Pitcher checks the runner at second. There's the pitch. Big swing, fouls it back off.
You know, Germany really needs that ground ball. They need to get out of this inning with a double play, get into the dugout, get ready to start hitting. This is a big inning for them. They have to stop Laredo here.
Yeah, they got six outs left, basically. Ball's in the dirt, but like we said, this catcher's doing a fabulous job behind the plate.
He really is. He really is. You know, if you're a pitcher and you're throwing to your catcher and it goes in the dirt and that catcher is doing everything to block that ball, that just makes you that much more confident that you could throw your curve into the dirt. You don't have to worry about it because you know your catcher's got your back. So this catcher today has done a phenomenal job just protecting that plate.
Here we go. 2-2, one out. Runners at first and second. Nice sharp ball. Shortstop catches it cleanly. Beautiful dive. That shortstop made a beautiful dive to stop that ball from going into left field. That's a forced out at second. That was a beautiful play.
That was a beautiful play. You know, and the fans here from Laredo are cheering that play because he went all out to his right. Not only did he catch the ball, but he had enough to know that he had to flip around and get that ball to second base. He throws a shot to second base to get that out. Fabulous play. That could be a saving play for Germany if they can get out of this inning.
You know what? That's true. That is very true. And he threw it from the ground to get it over to second base. Beautiful, beautiful play to get that force out. Runners on the corner for Laredo. Number 15, Francisco Hernandez up to bat. So we got two outs now. One ball. Runners on the corner for Laredo. Number 44, Kloppenberg is starting to settle in. This is his first inning of pitch here, top of the sixth inning. There's the windup and the pitch. Got to keep that runner honest down at third base. The catcher rifles it back down to third baseline. Beautiful, beautiful throw. Almost caught him.
Yeah, as a catcher, you know, that's kind of insulting that you have a player that's going to go too far down the third baseline. You have to check him. You have to let him know, I see you.
And he threw right behind the batter, too. It was a beautiful throw. Two balls, no strikes. Swing and a miss. Ball gets away from the catcher. No one's looking where it's at. Oh,
they're calling a foul ball.
I checked that. That was a foul ball.
Yeah.
That's why no one's caring.
But no. It sounded good, though.
It did sound good. I was getting excited there. That is a good question. Since Laredo is the host team, if they win this game, do they advance?
Yes, they do. Yes, they do. They play it out just like a regular team.
There you go. Thank you, Carla, for that question. 2-1's the count. Foul ball. 2-2, two outs. Runners on first and third for Laredo. Top of the sixth inning. Three outs left for Germany to mount any kind of comeback. Down by one run.
This is a big pitch right here.
Runners going from first. Swing and a little dribbler foul ball to the third baseline. So that runner is running from first base to kind of cut that, cut out any opportunity maybe to have a forced out at second to force them to go to first, basically.
Absolutely.
The wind is picking up here a little bit here at night now. All the flags are blowing straight out. So we got the wind coming in from right to left. Foul ball. Send that runner back to first base.
You kind of like this battle. You know, this is one of those battles where the pitcher has to take it personally. You know, this guy's fouling off so many pitches. I want to get him. And the batter, same principle. I'm going to take this personally. This guy is not going to get me out. This is what baseball is about, this little challenge right here. This is what gets me excited to see who's going to win this battle.
It's a chess game.
Absolutely.
Here we go. 2-2, two outs, runners on the corner. Keeping that runner checked out at first base because he has run the past two times. Pitcher says, hey, wait a minute. Get back over there, buddy. I can send you back. All right, here we go. Getting the call from the catcher. Pitcher's looking in. He likes the call. There's the windup. Checks him back at first base. Playing the little cat and mouse game now. Got to keep an eye on the runner down here at third base, though, also.
That's right. It looked like the third baseman said, wait a minute, you never checked me.
There's the pitch. Low one in the dirt. You know, for as much as this catcher's done today, that ball finally got away from him, but just dribbled a little bit off to his right. But he's fast enough to get out there. Pitcher ran down and said, I got you covered. And held everybody at bay. However, the runner did advance to second base. So now the force out at second is out the window. We got a full count, two outs. Runners on second and third now. And there's the pitch. And it's a free walk. Yeah. Little high. Next up to bat for Laredo will be number 16, Eric Reese.
Coach wants to talk to Reese.
You know, this is, you know, getting into that situational baseball now. You know, everybody from Germany is playing a little bit back. Outfielders playing middle. You know, this is a chance for Laredo. If they can blow this game open right now, what is it? Hernandez, right? Correct? The
right.
Pitcher for Laredo? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
He's been hot. You know, he's been hot and he's keeping them at bay.
He's getting rest.
He's resting right now. Nice hard hit ball to the gap. Oh, left fielder gets over to cover it, and that's the end of the inning.
Just like that. You know, this base is loaded just when you think Laredo's going to do something. Boom, Germany shuts them down.
And that last pitch for Germany was 82 miles an hour. Here we go. 5.5 innings of play so far. We haven't had a run since the fourth inning. Right now, Laredo sitting on top, 5-4 over Germany, going into the bottom half of the sixth inning.
And that's been typical of every game that we've seen. Runs early, you know, a little bit disorganized, a couple of errors, and then all of a sudden everything kind of calms down, the pitchers get into sync, and then you see a lot of zeros on the board, you know, and it's been like that every game we've seen. Call it first time jitters, you know, getting that first game out of the way, but it's been consistent that way.
Has been very consistent that way. That is correct. And here we are in the latter part of the game. You know, fifth inning, zero right now. Sixth inning so far, the top half, with zero runs for Laredo. You know, Germany's coming back up. Going to see what they can mount here. They got three outs or six outs basically left to either tie this game up or pull ahead of Laredo. Again, this is Pony League play. We play seven innings. Seven innings of play. You know, I don't think... Let me thank our corporate sponsors again real quick. Are you gonna? You had something you were going to say about
Germany? Yeah, I was impressed with these kids. You know, they're 18 years old or younger, but traveling 5,400, almost 5,500 miles to get here to Laredo. You know, just getting here, keeping their focus, getting ready for baseball. I mean, this is big time for these kids. You know, you know, who knows if these kids are ever going to get back, if they ever get back to Texas, you know, maybe the United States, but, you know, this is a memory that they're going to have.
Yeah, very true. This is, you know, this is Germany's first time here in Laredo at the Pony League World Series, their first time that they've made it out this way. Up to bat for Germany is number 24. Primozic.
I mean, we even had people that went to the airport just to see Germany get here. Just to see them get off the plane. That's how awesome. Excited people were.
That's awesome. Just like that, we got two strikes on Primovic. 0-2 is the count. That one came in at about 87 miles an hour. There's a windup and the pitch. Hard hit ball over the first baseman. The first baseman hands it clean. He flips it over to the pitcher. Just in time for the force out at first base.
You know, that particular play always gets me nervous. You know, everybody thinks it's such an easy play. You know, it looks so easy. The first baseman gets it. He just flips it to the pitcher. But the angle that the pitcher has to take to get there, and then he has to be able to catch the ball and step on the bag, that takes a little bit of coordination. Maybe I'm just not coordinated enough to do that play, but it just gets me nervous because people just think that's an easy play, and it really isn't. You know, it takes some execution.
No, it does. I agree with you on that. It was a bang-bang play there, and you never know, that pitcher might, you know, twist his ankle getting over there also trying to step on the bag, or he might get stepped on. You know, right now we got number 8 for Germany, Titus Van Kopp, up to bat. It's a 1-0 count. Arturo, thank you very much for the nice going, guys. We're trying our best. Thank you, Arturo. Here we are, 1-0, one out, bottom half of the sixth inning. The batter's getting ready, steps back in, he's ready to go. Pitcher gets the signal, here's the pitch. Big swing and a miss for strike number one. There's a windup. Pops it up over to the right side. First baseman giving chase, but it's out of play. Here we go. 1-2 is the count. One out. Nobody on for Germany. They got some players coming in from the bullpen back there down the right field line. Number 8, Van Kopp. In the box, ready to receive that pitch. Pitcher shakes off one. Here he goes. Relaxing. Here comes the pitch he likes. Just high. 2-2. Now, here's some, you know, fun facts. We have some fact sheets up here with us. Team facts about Germany. First team ever from Europe.
Wow.
To be here in the Pony League World Series. That ball's low into the dirt. Ball number 3, full count now. They recruit players from all across Germany. They won the German 18 and under national championships in 17 and 18. And they are a certified Major League Baseball International Academy program.
Oh, nice. Well, you can see some of the talent here. I mean, there's definitely talent that we're going to see down the road at the next level. They're just that good.
Was that a ball 4 or what happened on that one? I didn't see what happened.
Ball 4, yes.
Ball 4 got a free walk over to first base. I'm sorry, I was reading some fun facts.
You know what makes them very popular, though? Down here in this neck of the woods, soccer is king.
Yes.
You know, and when it comes to World Cup, Here, we cheer for U.S., we cheer for Mexico, we cheer for Argentina, South America. That's kind of like this area. That's what we cheer for. And we always hear about the big Germans.
The German national
team. The German national team.
Oh, yeah.
And how they play. And, you know, they talk about the leagues that they're in and stuff like that. So it's very impressive. And everybody talks about how fast, how big they are and everything. Then you see Germany's baseball team show up. And they're big. And they're tall. Just like their national soccer team.
Yeah, they are. Up to bat now for Germany is number 9, Kirchhoff. Will we be calling all the games? Carla's asking. Today, me and Orly are calling all the games today. We do have a team that's coming in on Saturday because I'm headed to your land in San Antonio.
He's quitting on me.
No, I left my last family vacation.
Come on, guys. Tell me he needs to stay.
It's the last family vacation before my daughter has to go back to school. That's strike number 1. They're 2-1 now on the batter. So I won't be here tomorrow. We do have a team coming
in. We have a kiddie park here at the stadium. Bring her over here. Let her play on the swings. Come on.
But there's no zebras or opakis or koalas or anything at the kiddie park. I'm just saying. Keeping the runner at check down to first baseline. 2-1's the count. 1 out. Runner on first base for Germany. Number 9 up to bat, Kirchhoff. So, no, we won't be calling all the games. We do have a team coming in on Saturday and Sunday. Then we'll be turning back around one more time on Monday's championship game. Throws it back down first baseline, keeping that runner on us. Almost got away from him. Able to come back in safely into first base. That ball was high. 3-1's the count now on our batter. We will be back Monday for the championship game.
Right.
Or any other games that we have on Monday. So we will be here Monday.
You know, we have some pros tomorrow.
We do have some pros tomorrow.
These guys are the sports announcers from the NBC affiliate.
Nice bunt. Down back to the pitcher. Turns around, throws it over to second base. Gets the force out at second. You know, and that seems to be the problem that we've been talking about Germany on their bunting. You know, they're bunting it back to the pitcher. They only had one good bunt that laid down the first baseline. He's not giving his runner a chance on that one.
No, and the pitcher had plenty of time to throw to second base. That play wasn't even close. So, yeah, we have the sportscasters from our NBC affiliate, our television station here in town. So they were nice enough to say, yes, they'll do some games. But, you know, those are pros. We'll see what people say.
We'll see what they say. Hopefully they'll be as funny as us. Carla's like, well, okay, I guess. Yeah. She doesn't want us to leave because, you know, hope they're as fun as us. So you got to let them know that. And then, of course, you know, I'll let you read the other one there. Also, nice hard hit ball to right field. Drops in. That was number 4. Waving the runner on his third base. Oh, he slid off the base. Catches him after that. Oh, my God.
Wow, what a break for Laredo.
It was a beautiful slide into third base. He was safe. But he slid so hard that he came off the base. That's number 9, Kirchhoff. Slid off the base. The player was able to tag him out.
Just getting ready to say that Kirchhoff hustled around second base, and he pushed himself to get to third base. And I was just going to say he just put his team in a position to maybe tie this game, and he slid right off the bag, and they were able to tag him.
Up to bat there was number 4, Vogel. Beautiful, beautiful shot to right field. I mean, that was a beauty. Laid it in perfectly. You know, and
exactly where he's supposed to put it, behind the runner.
Exactly, behind the runner. But, man, oh, my God, that was a bang-bang play. Another big break for Laredo on that one. Here we go. Getting ready for the top of the 7th inning, the last inning in Palomino play here today. Laredo still on top, 5-4. They got 5 runs on 8 hits, 1 error. Germany has 4 runs on 6 hits and 2 errors. Laredo's coming up to bat one more time. Thank you, Jay Liss. You know, we are trying to make as many positive comments as we can out here about our city and about the games that we have going on here. Yes, I understand we don't have a lot of people that come out here, as someone else put on there.
Yeah.
But, you know, we have families watching from all around the world. We had families from Puerto Rico watching earlier. We had families from Illinois watching earlier.
Yeah, we had grandmothers saying to say hi to their grandkids.
Yeah, we had Tia Maria saying to say hi.
Yeah, Aunt Maria.
Aunt Maria. You know, and we were able to talk to the players afterwards. Even one of the sisters from the Puerto Rican team said, hey, I taught him everything he knows.
That's right.
You know, and we talked to these players afterwards, and they got a big laugh out of it. They couldn't believe that we were talking to their families back home. Yes. You know, so this is great. You know, we're having fun with this. So far, this game right here, right now, has been the best game we've seen all day long.
It has been.
It's a really, really tight game. The players are giving it their all. They're putting everything on the line. And to use that old cliche, they're not giving, what is this there? They're giving everything they got, you know, they're leaving everything on the field, you know, and it's awesome.
It is.
It is awesome.
And after every game, the local Pony League sponsors their meals. So we get to get out of this box that we're in and walk over, and the teams, like, for example, Germany and Laredo, they'll go upstairs after this game and they'll feed them. So that's where we get a chance to talk to them and say, hey, your parents were you know, typing some text messages to us, and go.
At number eight, Gerardo Villal takes the first pitch into the back, gets a free walk over to first base. So, yeah, so like what are you saying, we get to talk to these guys after the game and let them know that, hey, we were communicating with your family and friends back home.
Right.
And let them know that, hey, they're watching you. They're cheering you on. What are our numbers right now, our viewers?
The viewers?
On the left-hand side at the bottom. Right.
75.
So this is it's all right. It's pretty good.
Yeah,
pretty
absolutely.
Good.
Absolutely. I'm happy with that.
I'm very happy
okay,
with that.
Okay, hey, I got one.
Uh-oh, here we go.
See, Harlingen played earlier, and they have a store over there that sells beef jerky.
Oh,
and,
yeah,
and
Alex.
You actually got Alex to say he'd bring you some coming this way. What if we compliment Germany and they bring us beer?
Oh.
Yeah. There you go.
You know, that's right. You know, Alex did say he was going to bring me some beef jerky from the Bass Pro Shop.
A shipment of beer.
The good stuff. The good stuff. Not the stuff you give to the foreigners.
No.
The good stuff.
We want the good stuff.
We want the good stuff down here.
Pitcher change for Germany, number 7,
Lebowski. So now we got a pitcher change for Germany. Number 7 is coming in. And his name is Lebowski. Stefan. Hope I pronounced that right.
Good-looking kid, nice, tall, lanky pitcher, right-hander.
Now, here is the last inning for us here. It is the seventh inning, so we're in the top half of the seventh inning. So, you normally in a major league game, you have the seventh inning stretch, right?
Right.
The take me out to the ball game.
Yeah, we can't do that.
No, we can't do that here.
No.
Why not?
We can start a tradition.
Just start a tradition.
We should.
We should definitely start a tradition. Yeah, I agree with Carla. All of these players are very talented. Very talented players all around. You know, again, from the teams from Chinese Taipei, from Germany, from Puerto Rico, from Texas, from California, from Illinois. I mean, right now, guys, you're seeing the best of the best.
You know,
these are the best of the best.
We have, in Laredo, we have a couple of tryouts here in Laredo, and one of the bigger tryouts brings in about 28 major league scouts. We get talent from all over the state of Texas. They come here to Laredo for a tryout, and so we have a good relationship. I heard from a little birdie that scattered amongst the crowd are some scouts that have come into town. They really don't want anybody to know. They just want to kind of sit back and watch baseball, but they heard about it, and they're here. We have some universities that have some representatives here that are watching the games.
Maybe one from about 4 hours away.
Are you talking about your Aggies?
Maybe.
Texas A&M Aggies.
There is a nice story about A&M in Germany also. Happened back during World War II. A grandfather happened to find an Aggie ring out on the battlefield. And they actually returned it to the university because it has a name on it, right?
Right.
His grandchildren attended Texas A&M University. After they visited the campus, they fell in love with it. And there's actually one there right now attending Texas A&M University. In fact, I think they just graduated this past couple of years.
So back to baseball.
Up to bat for Laredo is number 4. That's Campos is up to bat with a runner on first base. No outs here in the top half of the seventh inning.
You know, in the first game, during warm-ups, one of the players threw a ball.
Oh, that ball just got away from him. Looks like it hit the batter on the leg. And that's another free base.
Along the lines of getting hit, the cameraman took a hit to the hand, and it bruised up his hand pretty good. He's out there, though.
He's a trooper. He's our cameraman out there on the first base side in the visiting team dugout. They were just warming up, and it was an errant throw by the right fielder. And next thing you know, I see it. The hand goes up in the air, and ice packs came out.
And the scorekeeper here and ourselves, we all just laughed it off. We didn't
because we didn't get hit.
I didn't get hit.
I didn't get hit.
Yeah.
In fact, I'm in the air conditioning.
That's right.
And we brought a fan to keep us cool, too. They're checking over the runner, making sure everything's okay. He's down at first base. They're bringing in.
They're taking off some jewelry.
Oh, there you go. Taking off with some jewelry there by the batter.
It never fails. You always have that. That's almost the same situation as when they say turn off your cell phones for a lecture or for a speech or something, and somebody's phone goes off.
Or at the movies.
Or at the movies, something like that. You know, they're told in advance. Same thing here. These players know you're not supposed to wear jewelry. But, you know, it's that flash, that bling.
You got to have the bling. Major league players do it, you know. This is the first time he's been in the game, though. This is number seven. Mr. Tobada is in here. This is the first time he's been in the game. So, yeah, maybe he wasn't ready. He still had his chain on.
But how quick was that umpire at home plate to see that?
That's right. Carlos Hubb was
he got him.
Over there. Mm-hmm. Took it off. Takes the first pitch ball down in the dirt. One of those account. No outs. Runners at first and second for Laredo. Laredo's threatening.
Both hit by pitch.
Both hit by a pitch. That is correct. Both these runners have gotten on hit by a pitch. Squaring around the butt. Ball gets away from the catcher. Flies to the backstop. That's the first ball I've seen he's missed. Again, that was a 6-7 footer on top of him.
That's right.
Runners advance. The batter had actually squared around the bunt. So I'm thinking maybe the bunt's going to be off the table now.
It's off
the
table.
The runners have advanced.
And this is the kind of stuff that I'm talking about that Germany lets happen. What did Laredo do to have a guy on second and third? Absolutely nothing.
Nothing. There's a windup. Another high pitch there. 3-0 is the count. That one came in at about 78 miles an hour. That's right, Carla. He's got the eagle eyes.
Eagle eye.
And there's the first called strike right there. 2-1, 3-1 is the count on the batter. And pitcher checks the runners. There's the pitch. And there's another free base. That's four. So far in this inning, the top half of the seventh inning, all three runners have gotten on via two-hit batsman and one walk.
And one walk.
Yeah, three walks.
You know, was the last inning, the out at third, it wasn't Laredo did anything incredible. Germany just ran over the base and was tagged out. You know, all these breaks that Laredo's getting.
Yeah, it was a really nice hard slide into third base. Mm-hmm. And he just kind of came off the base just a little bit. And Laredo was wise enough to sit down and tag him out right there. So save that run from maybe coming in later on. Germany could still be out there, you know. Mm-hmm. Here we go. Number six now at the bat, Joel Hinojosa. Nice hard hit over to the second baseman. Second baseman takes it in to home plate. Oh, my God. They got the tag out at home.
The force out at home.
The force out at home. I'm sorry. The catcher throws it down to first base, throws it way too high. Ball sails into the outfield. Right fielder has to come in. Two runs scored for Laredo on that one. An error on the throw on that one.
A hard hit ball to second base. The play is at home. The catcher is ready. He catches the ball. Out number one is at home. He turns around to throw to first base for a simple out number two, and he throws it right over the first baseman, and two runs score.
And that's exactly what we've been talking about. You know, Laredo, they're hitting the ball. They're getting on base. They're trying to manufacture some But Germany is helping them out so much by these simple errors.
That's right.
Here we go. Runner at second base and one out. 0-0 is the count. Just high. Ball number one. That came in at about 79 miles an hour.
And with a guy on first with one out, you don't know what Laredo's going to do.
There's the windup and the pitch. Bunts it down the third base line. Checks the runner over. Takes over to first base for the force out at first. But that runner advanced from second base this way.
Right. And that was more of a slap. Instead of a bunt, it was more of a slap hit. Third baseman played it very nicely, and he made the throw. Third baseman's a very sharp player, and he has a strong arm. And he can get that ball over the first base. But that takes a lot of concentration also because it's not a hard hit ball. So he has to charge in, get the ball, and then a speedy runner running down to first base, he has to throw a shot to first base to get that out. So well played, two outs.
Two outs now for Germany, for Laredo, I'm sorry. Runner is in scoring position, though, here at third base after that play. Ball one on the batter. That looks like, let's see who's up to bat right now. It's number 14.
Nomar Garcia
is up to bat, number 14. Ball two, 2-0. That one came in at about 75 miles an hour. Thank you, Sanchez, for the applause there. Thank you very much. I guess that's for us. We're doing a good job, maybe. 2-0. Swing and tipped it foul. Foul ball. 2-1 is now the count on Garcia. I agree with you, Nicole. These German boys are big. I got to meet them down there as they walked in the opening ceremonies. Man, I felt like a midget. I felt small. You know,
and around here, they're like rock stars, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, they are. They are. And there's the pitch. Big swing and a miss. Strike number two. 2-2, two outs. Runner on third base for Laredo. Germany trying to stop the bleeding here, trying to get out of this inning. Could have been a bigger inning, though. I mean, they could have got more runs on that one. Gets the call from the catcher, and there's the pitch. Big swing and a miss. Strike number three, and that retires the side. Here we go, going into the bottom half of the seventh inning. Laredo now on top, 7-4. Now, here's a little bit of history.
Here we go.
Yeah, seventh inning stretch. According to one popular tale, William Howard Taft, the United States of America's 27th president, is to be thanked for this ritual. In 1910, Taft attended the opening day game of the Washington Senators at Griffin Stadium. As the story goes, by the seventh inning, the president, who tipped the scales at more than 300 pounds, sounds like me, was feeling cramped in his seat, so he got up to stretch his legs. The crowd, thinking the chief executive was leaving, rose to their feet out of respect, and the stretch was supposedly born.
Good story.
There you go. Just trying to bring some knowledge to everybody out here.
Yeah. Stuff that people can take to work tomorrow. It's Saturday, but yeah, Monday.
Never mind. Let's thank some of our sponsors here before we end this game here. Thank you to Linedecker Construction, Playmore Family Entertainment Center, the City of Laredo, the Laredo Visitors and Convention Bureau, Andy's Air, Person Whitworth, Morales and Orchards, Rudy's Barbecue, Blue Top Digital Reaper Graphics, Rotex, Advanced Spine Solutions, Tonsa Teens, Dental Pediatrics, Stat Emergency Center, Andy's Mobility, Liquid Studio Group, A-Rod Construction, and Sunbelt Air Conditioning. Guys, thank y'all very much for helping sponsor the 2019 Palomino Pony League World Series.
Did you announce your favorite?
Oh, I did, but let me say it again.
Yeah.
First of all, Blue Top Digital Reaper Graphics, of course, because
that's where you work.
That's where I work. That's right. The place, right? And my favorite place to hang out, Rudy's Real Texas Barbecue. The people there are great. The managers are awesome. The GM's great. And sometimes I get free food.
And I bet President Taft would have liked that place.
You know what? President Taft would have. He's a big guy. Yeah, he's a big guy like me. You know?
Big guy, yeah.
We would have liked it. We got some baked potatoes.
Right.
With some brisket.
When you walk in, they're like, hey, Kenny.
Yeah, pretty much.
Really?
Wow. Yeah, they say Duncan. Nice.
Duncan. Yeah, there you
or
go. Duncan.
Boo-boo.
What?
That's a nickname. They call me Boo Boo.
Boo Boo. All right.
I don't think because I look like Yogi or Boo Boo.
No.
It's just a funny thing. And they do have some very delicious breakfast tacos too.
Oh wow, you're there early in the morning.
Sometimes. But don't tell anybody. Because I'm usually at work. Up next for Germany is number 2. Darren Hesel. Number 2, Darren Hesel for Germany. Here we are at the bottom half of the 7th inning. Germany has to get some runs here to tie. They got any 3 runs to tie the game up. If not, that's the end of the ball game.
Right. Marco Antonio Raya is on the mound. So he comes in to relieve Francisco Hernandez.
Now, Francisco almost went the length of the game.
Oh, yeah. And it was planned. They took him out. That was planned.
That was a called strike on the first pitch there. Then squares around the bunt for strike number 2. Darren squares around, gets that called strike number 2. He misses the ball. But the third baseman was charging in. He saw that bunt was ready to come in. Here we are, 0-2 on the batter. No outs here in the bottom half of the 7th inning. There's a windup and a pitch.
Yeah, he swung.
He swung. He checked the swing there, and that's it. Strikeout.
Raya has that kick that we saw earlier today from Mexico. It's, you know, he's in his windup. He brings up his knee, and when his knee comes up, he kind of does a little jerk with his knee. He comes up and goes down, then comes up again. Then he comes to the plate.
A little hesitation.
A little hesitation there. That really works on your timing when you're a batter. You just got to figure that out.
Next up to bat for Germany is number 10, Bedlin. Nice sharp hit over to the third baseman. Third baseman bobbles it, picks it up. No play at first base, so he holds on to it so he doesn't throw it away.
Yeah.
Runners on now. Runners on. Did you think would you call that an error?
Yeah. You know, it's tough when you have to grade these as errors or hits or what have you, because they're trying so hard, you know, and you gotta mark it down as an error, but he tried.
Yes.
You know, and you kind of feel bad, but that's the game of baseball.
Next up the bat for Germany is big number 95, Luca Ranemann. Oh, he was taking a cut at that one. Swing and a miss for strike number 1.
I like how the scorekeeper asked us. So, you know, if somebody gets mad and says, what do you mean you gave him an error? He's going to say, oh, I didn't. The radio guys told me.
Yeah.
We have a window here that we could see the scoreboard guy.
Big swing and a miss for strike number 2. Yeah, but he bobbled that, so I guess you would call that an error, fielding error.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But, you know, you get a slower player, he doesn't get to the ball, and it's a hit. Yeah. This guy's quick. He gets to the ball. He almost has a chance to make the play. He doesn't make the play. You got to give him an error.
Yeah. Big cut, foul ball. Can you give him a hit and an error?
Yeah, let's do that.
We'll call it an error.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to create something new now. Here we go. 0-2, one out, runner on first base. Germany down to the last 2 outs. There's the pitch. Chops it back over to first base. Goes foul. Foul ball. 0-2 still the count.
Raya is one of those pitchers that it has good control. He has good stuff. He knows where he needs to put the ball. Right now he's been putting it away, and he's battling, but he's staying away from the inside. He doesn't want to get it too close. This batter can take it deep.
Reaches out for that one. Sends it foul down the right baseline. Hanging in there. He's gone through about 5 pitches already now. Yeah, Germany is quite aware of what they need to do here in the bottom half of the inning. They need to manufacture at least 3 runs to send us into extra innings.
Right.
Checks the runner at first. There's the pitch.
Well, they're calling a strike. They're calling him out. The batter's out. But the runner does advance to second base.
Yeah, it was a check swing. He, you know, check swing. Called a strikeout on that one. The runner advances on the pass ball. Now explain this to me. This is one thing that I don't understand. He ran to first base. Third strike, and the catcher dropped it. So, but he doesn't get to stay on first base.
The batter?
Yes.
No, he does not.
But they still have to throw him out.
Infield rule. Okay. So they don't have to. But the runner needs to run all the way to second base. They could have caught him, but he didn't. He didn't hesitate. He went all the way to second.
No, yeah, that runner ran all the way to second base. That is correct. Next up for Laredo is number 40. I'm sorry, for Germany is number 47. Eckermann. There's a windup and the pitch. Big swing and a miss. Strike two. 1-2 on the count. Two outs. Runner at second base. Germany's down to their last out here. Maybe right. Even their last strike, right? Laredo's on top 7-4 here in the bottom half of the seventh inning. There's the windup and the pitch. Woo, just a little bit low there. Everybody was already getting ready to run in on that one there.
Well, he snuck in a fastball is what he did. You know, he's ahead in the count, but he tried to sneak in a fastball. We'll see if he comes back with a slider here away from the batter.
Yes, first was occupied, so the runner advanced to second base on the pass ball. We got a full count now. Full count, two outs, runner on second base. That pitch clocked in at 90 miles an hour.
He's bringing it. That's why he's their closer.
First was occupied, less than two outs. That was the second out right there.
I would assume this is just going to be a straight-up fastball.
Here we go. Gets a call. There's a windup and a pitch. Hard hit ball over to the right side. Just foul. Foul ball down the first baseline.
It looks like that fastball was 88, 89 miles an hour.
He's bringing them. Throw the heater.
You know, it's full count, two outs. You're going to go with your best. You know, you're going to go with your best. If he beats you, he beats you, but you threw your best.
All right, here we go. Batter steps out of the box there for a little bit. Number 47 out there at the bat. There's a windup and the pitch. Big swing and a miss. That's strike game. Number three, and that's the ball game, ladies and gentlemen. Your final score here from Laredo, Texas, Uni-Trade Stadium. The 2019 Palomino Pony League World Series game number 4 for today. Your final score was Laredo with 8 hits, 2 errors, 7 runs. Germany on 6 hits, 3 errors, and 4 runs. Your final score tonight, Laredo 7, Germany 4. Let's see where they're moving on to tomorrow.
We'll have Germany will go on to play, and I am trying to figure this out here.
I agree with you, Carla. It was one great game. Thank you for listening in.
Germany plays Aroma Park, Illinois, tomorrow at 9 a.m.
Well, there we go. Germany moving downwards to the loser bracket to play Aurora Park, who lost earlier today. Right, Illinois? They lost earlier today. So moving on to play them. Thank you, tomorrow. We try our best. We hope we kept you guys entertained. And all goes out to these players out here. They did a fantastic job out there.
Again, a lot of fun.
A lot of fun today. Orly, thank you very much. We had a lot of fun here today.
We did. We really did. Baseball. We did. You know, and you know, yes, you have to go to San Antonio and do your duties, your fatherly duties, but we will see you back, God willing. You'll be here Monday for the championship game. So you and I will be doing that game.
That's right. We'll be back for the championship game on Monday night. Possibly three games on Monday, if not just one game. But here from Laredo, Texas, Uni-Trade Stadium. Final score one more time, Laredo 7, Germany 4. We'd like to say thank y'all very much for listening in. Thank you for coming out and enjoying this game. Good night, America, wherever you are. God bless. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you.